going in here. As far as you all know, this is just a ship that got fucked in the middle of nowhere. But what are you doing on board at the moment?
What is the job we're here to do?
As I say, on board there is a box that your employers want.
I think, yeah, I'm probably, like, behind, what was the name of the captain again?
Aboard, so the captain of this ship is Walker Schofield. You've had a little bit of a, hey, we need to have a conversation.
Yeah, so I'm just behind him. So, when we park up, what's going to happen is you're going to sit exactly right there, and you're not going to fly off, because if you fly off, we're trained killers, we'll come after you and we'll kill you. We all good? We're good and we good?
Schofield's just like, Repsorp, you said the same thing for the last 6 days we've been in transit. I've got it.
I'm very particular about not being left in space.
Like, I can understand that. And if I leave you behind, Jace and his boys are going to make sure that I don't make it to the next next planetfall. So we're all on the same team here.
Yeah, except one half of this team threw the other half in a huge pile of shit.
Fair. So, Notos and Ryla, what are you guys doing?
Ryla is relishing how many metallic clacks he can get out of all his beautiful, shiny new firearms that he's recently purchased.
Fair enough. How has Ryla upgraded then? Are you prepping your gear as we pull in?
I was genuinely trying to just figure out how. Because, unfortunately, I had all this written down. I've just checked my character sheet and my weapons. I've got the stats.
Yeah.
Like, the damage die and the rolls and how much ammo I've got. But the actual names for the guns are all missing. So I can't tell you for the life of me what I've got. So I'm just bringing up the...
Fair enough.
Many guns.
Beautiful. I believe the 3d8 will be a spike thrower.
Yes.
Yeah, it has to be.
That can't sounds right. I don't know what. So yeah, you've got like a bunch of new shiny mag weaponry lying around. Spits metal at high velocities at people.
Mag weapons. That's it. Mag rifle. Yeah.
If you've got one that's 2d8+2, I think it is.
Yeah.
That's a sniper.
Didn't you buy a rocket launcher? You were considering buying a rocket launcher. You were considering dropping all of your money into a rocket launcher.
I did buy it. Oh no, I bought a shit ton of upgrades and stuff.
Money did you have?
They made a lot of money out of that job.
Because Finbar's a stinky bastard. He never gives us the good stuff.
I think it was 15 grand. Like, we did go after, like, and there was a guy who, if you go up against him, he will literally skullfuck you. We were like, let's go for that guy, because that guy sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, and then they got some real good rolls out of it that they basically counter-hacked him because he rolled terribly on his much better computers, and so they got to, like, ram him into the ground, and yeah. I made him roll some physical effects saves, and he didn't do too well.
He tried to hack us, and instead I FaceTimed him, and then I was like, hey!
It was beautiful. Okay, cool. So...
power armor as well.
Say what?
I had pink power armor at one point.
Oh, yes. They got lent experiment. They conned Mr. Man aboard the Strahl into giving them experimental like combat suits. So they were running around like AC-2 suits for a session. You do no longer have that because that has
been
taken
back. Yeah, no, I know. Because you're a bastard.
I know, I'm the worst. I give you toys for a session. But yeah, okay, so you're there fussing over all your new equipment. Notos, what are you doing?
Well, Notos has spent most of this intervening time meditating and perfecting, mastering psychic abilities.
Okay.
After doing that the past couple of days, he spent most of his time teleporting around the ship and learning how to, after teleporting, come out into a commando role and land behind cover.
Good. Just have this image of just like, Ryla like pulling apart his rifles and like cleaning different parts of it. And then just there's a like, this flash of like, bright feathers, and notice like, ha, and then disappears again.
I can just imagine it's just like sitting at dinner. It's just really boring, and it's like, notice, can you pass this up? Oh, for fuck's sake!
It's good stuff. It's good stuff. Cool. Yeah. So, I think so. Yeah. Walker kind of goes over, comes across the comms like, right, ship's in sight. if any of you want to man like the scanners or anything like that, you may want to know. But I can see there's externals. Basics seem to say there's one undamaged airlock near the front of the ship. I'm gonna try and pull us up next to that. It's gonna take a little bit of some fancy flying, but hell, I've done harder. And yeah, so that you feel like the Texas Ranger starts to, like, swivel around, and from the outside we see it kind of pulling up next to and following the like rotation of the slowly spinning John Smith ship as he like starts trying to lock on to this airlock port. Yeah, are any of you doing anything in that like as reconnaissance for this thing? Because I mean, so I think what happens here is we cut back to like your video briefing as like the ships are like moving together, and you're all in the office, including what's his face, Gideon Wolf, the robot. So Ryler, just so you know, you've just been kind of called up of like, hey, we need you for a job. You walk into the room and there's a giant bird, like a bird man, and a silvery robot like with his hood down and like an LED blank LED screen for a face, I think it was, then this very very scared looking man who we now know, you now know as Walker Schofield, who's kind of sitting between the robot and Repsorb, who's this
cowboy, aging cowboy.
Yeah, and then on the other side of his desk is Eric as usual, and he goes, "All right, you're here."
Yeah.
Well,
there's a. Well, right, when you said there'd be birds, this isn't exactly what I had in mind.
Hilarious. Sit down. We have something to show. He taps a button, and this like projector comes on, and you see. So Jace from the planet Thrasmedes that you met, gentlemen, appears on the screen. He kind of leans forward and goes, "Hello, boys. Pleasure to see you all again." Figuratively speaking, of course. This is pre-recorded. I've found a way to call in that favour, so I'll let you know, and then you can go clear up all our money issues. So, he, like, taps and, like, some, like, pop-ups start appearing on the screen. This merchant ship called the John Smith, property of the Society of Curators, the SOC, as you probably know. They've got... The ship failed to check in a couple systems back. We have a vested interest in... apparently alerts have gone up that it hasn't arrived at its destination point over in... where the hell was it going? It was going to the planet Veloka, down in the Astonos system.
Fucking love Veloka. It's my favourite place.
Yeah, he continues, because again, this is pre-recorded. He's like, we would rather like it if they didn't necessarily find the ship. Or at least everything that's on it. Specifically, a case with, this pop-up is of a specific box of, like, it's pretty large. Looks like there's a lot of, like, security on it. Used to, like, it looks like something that would be transport, like, weapons or something like that. So chunky, lots of, like, mechanical, like, big-ass, like, grav locks and mag locks. The mag locks, not grav locks. Grav locks would probably be a little excessive on a box. A lot of, like, fancy, like, Ryler, you can tell those are some fancy computer systems, like, locks on that thing, like, shiny.
I love that. That's shiny. That's probably expensive.
Yeah, and it's like marked with it. There's like a seal on it of the SC and a little like a serial number. And he goes, "We would like it if that box didn't make it to the destination." Now I'll throw you a bone here, gents, because everything else you can find on that ship, including the ship itself, whatever you can take away from it, you're more than welcome to have. But we want that box. I've got a drop-off station. Little easier to get into than Thrasmedes. And he, like, some coordinates ping up. Get the box on board. Have our dear friend Mr. Schofield bring it along. And all this nasty business will be behind us. You might even be able to make some money on the side. Be warned, though. We lost contact with it out in, out in open space. Sector 205. No idea what's going to be happening around there. So, don't go in stupid. Over and out, gents. The thing clicks off. And Eric kind of like turns and goes, "Well, Schofield, I think, has agreed to fly you." He kind of looks towards towards Repsorp, like a, well, he's got a choice. "I'm afraid I'll be needing Gideon around to analyze some of the things you brought back from Thras Meadow, so." And he, I guess he notes that what's her face, Jenny's character name. Evelyn seems to have gone out of contact, probably blowing some of her salary from the last job in the bars. So, but Ryla here has proved himself pretty damn useful in a pinch.
I look confused, as if we've heard different sides of the story, but I don't say anything.
So, good luck, gents. Clear this up. Time is of the essence here. And yeah. I think we the scene kind of fades as the airlocks like locking together, and yeah, so I think you get like a little thing popping up so he kind of comes across. Seems to say there's no atmosphere inside, guys. Don't know what's going on. Ship's kind of a corpse by and large. You're gonna want to suit up. Be careful in there. Oh
God, no. Not exosuits.
Is this getting all dead spacey?
No, I just have to use exosuits, which means we get crap tons of minus modifiers unless you're trained.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
I'm not trained.
FYI, I am not trained. I'm so screwed.
We're so prepared.
Yeah, so we cut to like you guys suiting up. I mean, yeah. This probably isn't the most comfortable, unless you've brought your own spacesuit, Notos. This probably isn't particularly comfortable for you, because these things are not designed with your biology in mind.
No joy.
Yeah, because like you've got five-fingered gloves, which you're trying to put talons inside. Like, you're not in particular danger, like, unless you actively try, of like shredding through them. But like, yeah, it's definitely unwieldy as all hell. You kind of like you keep accidentally pecking the visor of the helmet. But yeah, you eventually, like, you sort of help each other into your suits. Don't you have exosuit,
no.
Ryla?
Oh, wait, not Ryla.
I have... What, training, or...?
I thought you had, like, a point in exosuit skill. Because that was why you could run around in the, Yeah, you have a zero in exosuits. So, yeah. Like, Ryla's pretty competent, so I guess it's like, yeah, it's Ryla suits up in no time, and then, like, turns around and you guys are all dicking about.
Didn't have exosuits out in the old Wild West.
Wait, are these exosuits referring to the ones that are called vac suits?
Yeah, the exosuits refers to kind of the vast variety of, like...
So you're giving us a free vac suit?
I mean, he's got some on board. He might want them back. That's up to you guys to negotiate.
He's not getting them back.
Yeah. So, yeah, you're suiting up. But yeah, sorry. Exosuits covers like everything from vac suits to basic spacesuits, all the way up to like power armor. It's stuff that like is additional on top of clothing generally.
Generally involves systems. That's the big thing about it. Like,
it's the equivalent of being proficient in heavy armor in like D&D, except it covers loads of things. Some spacesuits. Yeah, so the like airlock doors like slide open and the air inside rushes out into the John Smith. And yeah, you seem to be on kind of like a pretty large
Wait, did we actually not do any sensor stuff? Like, I mean, you're the experts.
Yeah, you can say that. Sure. I mean, you could suggest that as a thing.
Like, can you like tech some stuff on this?
No, just the same. I think Ryla is actually your computer guy, weirdly.
Yeah.
Can you do a scan of the ship, or maybe on their systems? That would be easier, I assume.
I could probably like log into the ship and find out why where there is pressure and stuff like that.
Yes. Also, the ship logs would probably be pretty useful if you get hold of those.
Cool.
I will find out what happened to the ship.
I mean, I'll attempt it, but I make no promises. But I did take. So would that be computer logging?
That would
in?
Be computers. Yes.
Cool. Rolling.
Streamers
with...
just see me roll something, but.
Do I roll it with?
It's intelligence.
Intelligence.
That roll, Fimba.
Okay. So yeah, that tells you, like, so the ship is, yeah, it's like, there's a limited amount of, power in certain systems, which is weird, like, the ship is running in a strange way, like, the gravity's on, but the life support's off. The spike drive seems pretty unresponsive, from what you can tell, with the surf scan, and like, yeah, there's obviously a lot of systems damaged around the place that has a hole blown out of it, but you're like, oh wait, that's because it isn't there.
Yeah.
So yeah, you do a few scans. This one, the place you're headed into puts you a good few, like, you have to cross the ship before you'll get down to the big cargo hold where your stuff is stored, or theoretically your stuff will be stored.
What's a ship that one is.
I like how optimistic you're being about this, Finbar. Theoretically, your stuff is there and it'll be easy.
Yeah, well, so you pull up and, like, yeah, this, like, main cargo hold is down at the, kind of, the bottom deck, Delta deck. And you are, like, you're coming in literally, like, it's, like, behind the bridge, almost. In kind of, like there's, like, kind of, this ship is just about big enough that it's got, like, a little cockpit and some bits in there. And then, like, behind that, there's actually room for, like, whoever's senior to, like, sit in. It's kind of, this place is laid out a bit more like the Firefly, in Serenity, sorry.
Yeah.
So, like, you're docking kind of in that little chunk between the cockpit and the kitchen.
Yeah.
And you've got to get the whole way down to cargo. And
it's a fairly small ship, then.
It's bigger than what you're in.
Yeah.
Like, you're thinking how it's, like, five people. This thing does have... It's laid out similarly, but on a larger scale. This place probably takes about, like, 20, 25 people. But the thing is, a lot of its systems have been scrapped for cargo space. Right. Like, it's as close as you get to a freight liner in this day and age.
Is there any way to... Yeah, have you managed to access the ship's logs at all?
I think it's a lot, as I say, a lot of these systems are just powered down. So if you can get to, like... It does say, like, if you can get to, like... It seems a lot of the stuff looks functional from, like, a few, like, ticks coming out of, like, maybe the black box of it. It's, like, a status report from just it went down. It's like, the ship is in okay shape. They reported weird power surges. But, like... You don't get enough the reports aren't detailed enough for you to, like, figure out what that means. I mean, it could just have been like, hey, you get power surges and short circuits when half the circuit goes missing.
Yeah.
Yeah, you do get a, I think you just about managed to get a few things saying, like, that outside of that specific area, like, the thing isn't, like, compromised. So if you could get somewhere to turn stuff back on, you could feasibly turn life support and the ship back on.
Yeah, in which case I sort of relay this and I say, well, she's in piss poor shape, but she's still airworthy or space worthy. And I mean, if we can turn life support back on, hypothetically, we don't need these suits. But I want to check the hull before we do anything crazy like that. Oh, yeah. And I can't really figure out why she's offline. It's looking a bit, well, from my eye, I'd say sabotage, because. It seems to be pretty particular what's gone offline.
Alright, well, I would say the job of it here is get what we need, get as much else as we can, then blow the ship and get the hell out of here. That way, because we can't keep the ship because that belongs to someone else, we don't want to take stuff from the ship and them to know that we took stuff from the ship because it all belongs to someone else, so we take the ship, blow everything else.
I mean, I'm just going to point out some things here, like, the ship is, like, probably not quite space-worthy, especially if the spike drive is fucked. Like, you're not getting it out of here unless you have, like, a tow truck in space. But...
Is that not an equivalent of the AA these days?
Probably, but they charge and usually probably just, like, a lot of money, I imagine. And it will just, it's less the AA and more, hi, do you have, like, a ship capable of housing another ship? Can you go pick ours up? And they might just take it from you, because usually there's be governments. But salvage on something this size? That's a lot of money.
It's also the sort of thing, at the end of the day, like, it would probably cost what it costs to get the ship in the first place just to salvage it.
What are salvage rights in the universe?
So, the legal... is the thing. Legality in outer space is very much like... So, this is a ship that is made and owned by the SOC. But then again, there's an element of finders keepers. However, they might not see it if they find out like that, if they find you took it from them. Legally, there's no police here.
Yeah.
There's no law here.
But
there's
they
no
would
one to,
probably
yeah, but
still be pissed.
They would be pissed, and they would, if they found out it was you, they'd do their best to make your life difficult.
Yeah.
Or get it back, either way.
I still say we just go with taking shit and blowing it.
But yeah, then again, it's like, if you can do it quickly, if you can get in there quickly enough, they may never know it was you. And cover your tracks well enough.
We're not very good at covering tracks, that's not
risk-reward kind of deal.
Yeah.
Okay,
so, first off, that's, alright. Do we particularly care what happened to these people? Possibly. I would say we should head to the the pilot, the flight pilot's cabin. Not cabin, but like what's it called? The flight deck.
Bridge.
Yeah.
Bridge.
If they died to an airborne flesh-eating virus, yes, I care what happened to them. If they died because of their own incompetence, no, I'm not so bothered. It's very much, that's my opinion.
Head to the bridge is probably the best to find out more information from there.
Okay.
Can I, like, lock the airlock in such a way, can I use security to lock the airlock down so that nothing can get into our ship? From here.
I mean, like, the ship has inbuilt, like, hey, you can't open our ship up without,
there's not just a door handle, there's probably a lock.
Yeah, like, it requires, like, authorization codes or someone inside the ship to open it, things like that. There's two ways you could do that spring to mind for me, at least.
Yeah.
One is, like, it has inbuilt stuff, but feasibly Ryla could beef up the computer security on it. The other way is, like, you booby-trap the door.
Yeah, the other way is just
uncouple from the ship and make sure that fucker comes back.
But I'd quite like to be able to get out in a hurry if necessary.
Yeah, no, that's fair enough.
The other thing I realized is the... pilot's captain, I assume, is at, like, one end of the ship, right?
Yes.
And so we're heading towards that. Can I set up a booby trap thing, like, basically with a bell, I guess, to alert us if something comes towards the cabin from the other end of the ship?
So you want to set, like, a motion detector?
Basically, like... yeah, motion detector.
Okay.
In the corridor towards the captain's cabin.
Yeah, sure. Give me a security roll. One second, I'm looking at chat. So, roll it.
Security with int. Oh, security with int. Oh, fuck. Can I really dexterously make this?
No.
Really
dexterously. I keep forgetting, like, whenever I want to do anything smart, it's just like, oh, no, damn it.
Why am I so stupid? Yeah, you just don't have the components. Right.
Yeah, it's fair.
Yeah, it's just a thing of, like, you want to build, like, a motion detector, like, it requires a camera and all this other, and it's like, oh, I just don't have the shit to do that.
What I actually need to do is take points in leadership and just be like, you, do this, take a plus one, and do it.
Fair enough.
That's how I do my ideas.
Yeah. Is that how leadership works?
It could, feasibly, yeah.
Always leadership's kind of cool.
Leadership is very much a thing of, like, do you have subordinates? And then it's like, you can hold together a unit of soldiers. So if Wildcards grows into a PMC, leadership might be quite useful. In the same way that if Wildcards gets a bunch of ships, piloting and navigation might become very useful.
Hold on, PMCs in a role-playing game, that's a stupid idea.
Yeah, no, those... Well, I would say those never work out well, but does never work out well. West Marches references. Yes, so... Okay, so yeah, you clump in there on the side of the inside the helmet camera from like Repsorb of was like, you know, the air exchanges, kind of ungainly feeling. Yeah, like a very awkward Notos kind of follows afterwards. Yeah, so where's destination one?
You got like the bridge.
The bridge. Okay. Yeah, so I think there's the thing of like, there's no power in this place, and all the doors are closed because everything locked down when a rupture happened. As the best it could, certain sections didn't do it very well, obviously. So can you? So like, how do you want to get in?
I look at.
Map posted on all the walls at regular intervals.
Well, I mean, like you get to. That you could, I think it's a rough schematic of the ship was downloadable. Like pulled off, like just the scanners were like, hey, this is what the layout of the ship looks like, and combine that with a little bit of knowledge of like how ships work, you know where the bridge is. So you're at the door, but there's a big fuck off bulkhead in the way.
I look at Ryla and point at door.
Cool. Ryla looks at door. Obviously, like, is there some sort of is there like a interface of any sort?
Yeah, there's cool. Like a keypad next to the door.
I'll see if I can computerize this bitch open.
With your super fancy smartphone.
Indeed.
Ooh, that's convincing.
Yeah, sure. So you hook in, tap some buttons, door slides open.
I type in password. No, password 1. Yes, we're in.
Yeah, like you have to do a few little fancy bits because you have to like power it up a little bit,
then
hack it in that small window of time when it's got enough. When you're running like the battery, the power supply to the door off your phone battery.
Yeah.
But yeah,
I've just got a lemon and I'm just like powering it off a lemon.
Potato battery, yeah. A spaceship. Yeah, but like door slide open. I think, yeah. So, Ryla, you're right at the door, and the doors go, whoosh, and then this, like, so a person, like, flops into you and, like, starts, like, pushing against you. What does everybody do?
Onto who?
As in, like, comes straight through the door, hits Ryla, and, like, tries to bowl Ryla over.
Point our guns at him?
Can I just, like, athletics, like, grapple it and not get bowled over, basically?
Sure, yeah. Give me that athletics. How fucked are you for being in an exosuit?
I'll have to go back to. I think it's. Wait, goddammit. Where was it?
Scrolling up to skills, see if it's there.
There you go. -2 penalty to all hit rolls and skill checks that require movement.
Okay, so yeah. You're a -2. To your normal athletics.
Yeah. Cool.
It's great, isn't it?
Yep. I'm just thinking, I don't have anything. This. Yep. Where's my athletics? Can I dive out the way instead of... Actually, it makes no difference.
Well, it's hitting Ryla, so, like...
It's Ryla, isn't it?
Because he's the one at the door fucking about with things. I thought you were, like, running up to, like, tackle it.
Yes, I completely missed that. In that case, can I get a look at what it is?
Not, like, immediate reaction time. Like, because it is literally Ryla's in the doorway. Doorway goes, whoosh, and then this thing hits him. Or, like, is about to hit him.
I'll go to grapple off.
Okay.
Assistant 0. Oh wait, this. Oh, I have to put -2 on this, but it's an 8.
Yeah. So you run up and like grab this body and like slam against the wall, and yeah, you realize it's a corpse. That just kind of fell out as it was like up against the doorway. And yeah, it's just like, ugh.
Just like, I just throw it down the corridor.
Yeah.
No, I don't.
I examine the body.
I examine it for like, it's like name tag or like, how did it die?
Yeah.
I go, tell me, how did, what happened here as I hand this to Notos?
Have a corpse. Yeah, I mean, if you...
I realize, wait, I don't examine it. I'm bad at the exam.
Yeah, I mean, like, a quick pat down is nothing particularly beyond you. Like you get a key card, and like an ID pass. Mm-hmm. And this guy was, I think second in command of the ship. And I haven't got a name for him, so he's going to be,
Radley.
Lieutenant Radley, I love it. Yeah, so Lieutenant Radley. And yeah, like, I think... If you have, do you have any kind of medicine or anything like that, Notos? Yeah, give me that roll then. See, you can see if you can work it out. It's not too difficult.
Oh God, where's it gone?
He died because he is missing his head.
it's a headless corpse.
Which attribute do I roll it on?
Be wisdom or I think wisdom for that one.
Yay.
I think wisdom or in one of the two.
Not assisted. And that's an 8. I assume there's no negative on... Is it negative?
Yeah. Using your brain is not a thing that is affected by this.
I don't know, I might have had to use my hands.
It's still kind of awkward as you're like kind of... but yeah, it's a few quick glances and like the general state of him. Like a few readouts pop up of like the temperature of this guy is this and da da da. It's like he died of asphyxiation. I think... As the same Firefly, he froze first. Then, like, no air. Then everything else.
Yeah, so Notos just looked at them and went, well, it's what you'd think, really.
Cool.
Tap. Like, every time you talk, your, like, beak taps the front of this thing. Yeah, so I think, yeah, Ryler, as you kind of at the door again, you sweep in, and there's another body in a similar state at the, like... sitting in the pilot's seat. And yeah, another the depowered room, the windows out into
are there any
space beyond.
Shelves in this room?
Is there pressure in this room?
Sorry?
Is there pressure in this room? Is the
No. The life support is off, so like
technically... No, but I mean like is the viewing glass just gone or like
No, it's there.
Okay, cool.
It's there. Yeah. It's just a thing of, like, the life support turned off, so eventually everywhere ran out of oxygen.
Yeah.
So, are there any cabinets in the bridge?
I'm trying to think. Like, it's mostly just computer banks. What are you looking for? Tell me what you're looking for, and I'll tell you what.
Just if there's any miscellaneous stuff in cabinets.
Not really.
In every
like,
single room we go into.
This is kind of there might be like a first aid kit of some description on the wall, or and a fire extinguisher.
I'm wasting money on one of those.
I'll take the first aid kit.
Yeah, I mean this is just like a pretty basic like. It's got some gauze and bandages.
Hey,
those
medikits cost 100 credits.
Really? There's no like Lazarus patch or anything like that in here. It's
just a medikit which gives you +1 to doing stuff.
I think this is more a medikit that allows you to treat a wound as opposed to a medikit that like.
So would you say it has a broad supply of pharmaceuticals, spray bandages, glues, and a succinct handbook of injury care?
No, I would say it has like a spray bandage and maybe some like burn cream. It's just a thing of like first aid on the fucking scene,
and then we're not picky.
Cart them up. So yeah, it might supplement your main med kit, it supplements your main med kit, but it's in no way like a full on replacement for everything in there. This is just kind of like this is the equivalent of something you get like, a teacher carries around. It's just like put a bandage on it, and if anything's actually bad, we throw them into someone who has actual medical ability.
So some paracetamol and water. That's what you're saying.
Yeah, that's it. That's
it's a strepsil. Two strepsils and some bandages.
Yeah, I'm putting supplemented in brackets next to my med kit now.
Okay, good. Okay. Good. Yeah, you got a fire extinguisher. Yeah, so...
I'm taking that.
Yeah.
As we begin to play this game like a point-and-click adventure.
later on, you'll find the doorway that can, like, you have to, like, lever it open, hammer on the lock with the fire extinguisher. And then for some reason, as soon as you do so, the fire extinguisher will disappear from your inventory. Oh, God. Okay. So, yeah, you get into the bridge. What's next on the list of things to do? What do people do as they fan out and around this room?
Well, I guess we're just waiting for
Ryla to
inspect things.
To Ryla to do some more computer shit.
Okay.
Cool. So Ryla's gonna walk over to.
Yeah, I think so. I'll just kind of give you this one for free because you've already accessed these systems once, like it's the same system basically.
Yeah.
So you just have to like power it up.
Yeah.
So yeah, you like. Kind of reach that, like, pop open a panel and, like, jimmy some wires and rig them up to, like, a battery or something. Just, like, give it some juice for a couple minutes. And then just mass dump information onto your data pad.
I take a massive dump onto my information pad. What do I get?
That's a bit inappropriate.
So what are you, like, looking for in here? It's, like, just give me an idea of, like, the kind of what you want to know.
I'll take manifest, black box recording, and yeah, anything else that looks helpful.
So I think you get like the shipping manifest is kind of it's less specific and like it's a lot of like serial numbers. And you find your like hashtag like 347-1Z. I'm gonna write this down in case I have a reference again. #347-1Z.
I'm gonna be looking for that specific item.
Yeah, well that's your one. Like that's the box you're here to get.
Yeah.
There's not much like listed on here about what's in them, except for like size and location to hold. Yeah, you also get a more detailed schematic of the place and like an up to date version, like the system switch on, does a brief like internal diagnostic and goes, here's a map and the place you shouldn't walk right now because we have no like actual like there's no ship there. So unless you want to jump it.
Do not breathe in these places because you cannot breathe in these places. Real helpful stuff.
Yeah. So yeah, you find a couple like things like that. So the black box stuff is like it shows a lot of power surges, but, like, you look at, like, I think maybe a reactor output and, like, stuff like that, and none of them show strange, like... So the times of these power surges don't coincide with any, like, significant change in the function of the reactor.
Cool.
But a bunch of them happen, and then the reactor just turned off.
Cool, so this more looks like an EMP than anything else.
Yeah, except for, like... there's no, like, reference in the black box, like, any log of, like, combat happening.
Yeah, yeah.
The other thing is the first system to go offline was the spike drive.
Right,
the
okay,
first,
so...
Yeah.
This is very much looking sabotage. This is, like, to Ryla, this looks like sabotage, like...
It definitely looks internal. I guess sabotage might be the natural jump.
Yeah, no, like... I have my own theory, but Ryla's just looking at it.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is sabotage. So
yeah.
He looks at everyone else and says, this is sabotage.
Sabotage? You mean this ship just randomly broke down and people died in the middle of space and it was sabotage? I'm shocked! That never happened in the old world.
No toss once again. Looks
very
at Johnny's character like he is a crazy man.
Repsol's kind of a dick.
Yeah. But there appears to be no signs of... Can we check... Like, is there security cam still working on this at all? Actually, there's no, like, no power, is there?
There's no power. I don't think they're, like... The juice it was given was enough to, like, resurrect the security centre.
Alright. Let's head down to the hold, then. Via the route we now know is safe.
Yeah.
I was gonna say, I wouldn't go for safe.
Okay. I mean, I don't know. Do we want to go to life support and switch it back on?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably, like,
considering we're all taking minuses at the moment because of life support.
Yeah.
Yes. I think
yeah,
so.
Yeah, and then, like, you have a certain amount of time on the ship. You might want more time.
Yeah, let's go life support then, by the safest route.
Fair. Okay. So, do any of you have anything like, what is it? What's the skill called? Astronautics? Or
tech
astronautic or anything like that? Like, I mean,
or culture spacer.
I'm more thinking along the lines of, like, are you looking out for things you could feasibly salvage and run away with that might be worth credits?
I've got a zero in culture spacer and what was that, tech?
Astronautics.
I've got no.
Fair enough. I just wonder, like, I mean, if you're looking out for things that might be worth money.
Yeah, we are checking every room, so anything any of us would notice.
I have business.
I have vehicle space and post-tech, but nothing that's specifically.
Yeah.
It's like various gizmos. Up for the ship that was salvageable, but as opposed to, like, just shit lying around, though.
Fair. Okay. I think, yeah, there's no real skills that directly lend themselves to that, so it's like,
obviously,
pull some cabling out of the wall.
Not pulling cabling out of the wall, we want to turn it back on.
Yeah. And then, yeah, like, short of that, you're not getting
Violet's
something
just like,
out
look how much this copper's worth, and I've, like, ripped out, like, this is, like, vital life support, do not switch off.
Yeah.
Yeah, strip it down for copper.
Oh, dear, so get, like, the SSE find their ship, just float, just like, all of the wires are gone. The ship is still here. As all is gone. Someone came and stole the wires. Yeah, so you head towards the engineering, like, you have to, like, crack a few more doors open, things like that, but nothing stands up particularly long. It's Ryla's coaxing hand, and the battery on his phone is getting awfully low at this stage. You do pass, as you go through, like, the mess, I think, or, like, it's almost a, there's a little, the little room at the very, top, like.
Question, is there gravity in this thing, or are you all, like, floating?
Yeah, that's a system that's for some reason online still.
Okay.
I mean, part of it, yeah, I mean, part of it is that the ship is just kind of, the whole spinning space station thing.
If it had no gravity, that would have been real fun.
Yes, for you it would have been. I mean, you feasibly turn it off, if you like.
Because that would advantage one out of three of us. That makes complete sense.
I don't know. Yeah. It may disadvantage one out of one of whatever else is in here. So that could work.
Yeah, so I think as you're kind of working your way through the... So you're working your way through this place. And, like, yeah, you're at, like, the sixth door. You have to wait for Ryla to crack open. And, yeah. Repsorp, you're kind of sitting there going, ah, oh, Jesus. And you see, like, a little comm message coming through from Walker aboard the Texas Ranger. And I think we cut to... We're on the Ranger, headed back from Thras Medes. Notos, you're there, obviously. Evelyn has kind of thrown up her hands and retreated to her cabin in disgust. I think maybe Gideon is very interested in that, like, briefcase and the things inside it that you picked up on the job. And is kind of examining those. Yep. And also, maybe it's like, I don't want to... Oh, my God. What? Cracky donated £9. One nat 20 for each player's next roll.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Thank you very much.
Shit, I like you.
I will split that, so a nat 20 in a combat situation or a 12 in a skill check.
We need to start... So I try and fix the entire ship.
I think that you get, like, you'd still get a 10 with that, is the thing.
No tops, fix the entire ship.
Telekinetically just pulls it together. Thank you very much, Cracky, for the £9. That's a weird size. Why is that
thank
a weird size? I'm gonna just change the size that a little bit. Okay, there we go. That looks good. Cool. So yeah, I think Gideon's kind of just avoiding the conversation a little bit because, like, his weird programming is like, this guy's my friend, I don't want to be mad at him. You have no such qualms, gentlemen. So, yeah, what are you saying to Walker now that you're off-world?
Is he sitting in his pilot seat?
No, I think he's come down, talked to you, maybe there was, like, or maybe he is still in his pilot seat and you guys are like, dude, get the fuck in here. tell me how it goes down. I don't know. This is kind of you guys' end.
Well, Notos assumes that Repsorp is going to go crazy, so he just kind of looms in the background looking menacing.
Yeah, he's picking, flex off his talons.
Comes up and
picking his teeth.
Friendly, nice and friendly. So, buddy, about how you fucked us up the arse. great fun, by the way. Lovely fellow you send us to meet. He's a real charmer. So now you work for us forever, and we get 20% of all profit you ever make, ever. Or when we make it to the next system ever, we engage the autopilot and you get blown up.
Is Noto's just there laughing in the background?
His actual composure is gone. Completely expected to strong arm a bit, not such ridiculous accusations.
Basically, like, hey.
It's like, squawk, it's all intimidation's gone. He's kind of like squawking and gasping like some kind of demented chicken.
Oh god. Let's play roles on the D10,000 Wild Magic Surge table. I need to change the rules when we play. Wild cards, because that doesn't make a lot of sense here. And also, I don't know where it is.
It's, you can find the link. It's down in our donation, so...
Okay.
Oh, bitch.
Okay, I can do that. Oh, and I just lost
it. It's just wild warps things happening.
Yeah, well, I can work on a good way to bring that in, don't worry. So, yeah, we'll do the scene, and we'll roll in the break, and some interesting things will happen. But yes, thank you, Cracky, for £15. That's £24. Jesus, man.
Dude.
The yeah, he just donated that to make everyone roll on the D10,000's search table, so.
I only saw 12.
Yeah, so we'll do the scene, and we'll roll on the break, and some interesting things will happen as a result. Okay, so.
Can I roll to persuade this guy to do
this? Yeah, sure.
Oh, wait, I just got a 12.
Oh, yeah, you get a 12, don't
plus
you?
Plus one, just a 13.
Fucker.
Yes. So I'll take that 20% profit for the rest of my life.
I mean,
that would go to wild cards.
Yeah. His profits are like a dubious thing when you control him. But yeah. I'm trying to think, like, what wiggle room do I have here? Because it's a pretty meaty thing to roll into persuade.
I'll tell you what I'd be happy with compromising is that basically he's now in hired and is a formal employee of Wildcards, basically.
Yeah.
He's
got a few months of free work.
Yeah.
Thing as well. Yeah.
So basically I'm in good books of...
Yeah, so I think, yeah, okay. I will officially, yeah, I'll add the Texas Ranger and Captain Walker Schofield to the list of things Wildcards has going for it. But yeah, so like he's kind of bold. It's like, okay, right, fine. I didn't realize he was going to make life so hard for you guys. I thought this would be just quick and easy. Sorry. Okay, we'll ease back on the, servitude thing, fella, but I'll put in a few months with Eric and flying you lot around the sector and, yeah. That
excellent,
work
I'm glad
for
we
you?
Can put this all behind us. You know, it's been a lovely day. Well, it was a very successful mission, actually, to be honest. Like, I got my name out there, so, yeah.
Then
yeah, just
fly
us around.
Laughing fit to like, oh my god, that actually worked.
Yeah.
Just shocked. And then just walked away in disbelief at this entire situation.
Yeah, so the one thing I do is Gideon holds up one of these little things and is like, I think he's doing the robot voice comes through. It's like, this device appears to show a strange, appears to be some form of Psytech device. And I think we'll... He kind of, looks towards you when he says that. It's like, that might interest you. But yeah, this is the briefcase that they picked up from the Sons of the Spike freedom fighters / terrorist group on Thras Medes. And within it were, four kind of, black, triangular sticks, about yay long. It's almost like a pen. It looks like reasonably fancy technology. Surprising for that kind of group to have, to be honest. There are four of those, and then a data pad.
What are we doing with those again?
Well, they were kind of supposed to be wild cards as payment job.
Right, yeah.
You guys got about 750 credits each. It was a pretty low money job. This was you guys were being paid out of wild cards' personal funds, whereas this box was like the payment they were giving to the company. Yeah. So maybe you have a scene at the beginning of the next one where you go like, hey, the fuck is that? But yeah. So I think we'll cut to the... We'll end part one of this week here. And the last scene we'll end is... So that we cut to the outside of the ship and it continues to roll, we see the Texas Ranger moves slowly away, and we see in the actual like cratered part of the ship, we see a small shuttle is moored in there. There's a couple people in exosuits like bursting way through a door. The first one goes we cut into like inside his helmet and we hear hey Ravi. Something pinged up on the sensors. Someone sent out a scanner pulse. I managed to hide us from him, but looks like we've got company inside. There he goes back. Comes back on site. All right, Echo. You stay in there. Stay safe. Let Gora know what's going on. We'll keep an eye out. The captain like reaches down and you see him like loosens a few things around a pistol hanging at his side, and kind of, I think a pink, as I say. Vasily, Adam, got up. Doesn't look like it's going to be quite as easy as we hoped. We slowly zoom out, and then behind, one of these big, meteor chunks, we see a ship about the same size as the Texas Ranger, and on the side we see the Serpentine. And, that's where we'll go to break. So... We shall return shortly. Don't go anywhere. Back in 2 minutes.
I'm now going to go somewhere.
Alrighty, Roo, ladies and gentlemen, I do hope you're having a fun time. Yes, we shall be back in just a moment. Don't go anywhere. Don't remember, if you haven't followed the stream and you are new, please do so. We very much appreciate it. As for other things that Encounter Roleplay does, we stream under normal circumstances, Monday through Thursday, every week. Obviously, with it being Christmas, some things are a little up in the air. Because, you know, it's the most stressful time of the year. Yes, please hit that follow button. Our sort of social media and YouTube things can be found down in the panels below the stream. We can find all of our old stuff, including previous sessions of Wildcards. Find out when we're streaming and all that jazz. But do follow. At every 50 followers, we do a viewer decision where things go horribly, horribly wrong and GMs cry. And we are a good chunk away from it, but we don't get close unless you guys help. So, yeah, back in a moment.
understand why.
Hello and welcome back to part two of week four of Wildcards, where things have been rolled on the Wild Magic table, and they are being translated into sci-fi in my brain, and soon enough we'll hit the pavement. You guys get let's just do some admin of rolling HP and things for people who've leveled up. So Josh, you rolled 2 and 1, so that only would give you 3 HP, so your HP doesn't change. And Repsorp has an 11 plus your con modifier twice.
That my con modifier is 0.
There we go. 11 HP as opposed to 8.
Yeah.
Pretty good. It's not half bad.
And especially if we're about to go into firefight.
I went from 5 to 7 in the pregame.
It's good stuff. So you get to finally engineer like the kind of main like bay for like life support, reactor core, that sort of stuff. Things that aren't engine directly, kind of run a separate power. Like they're probably powers the like non spike drive engines, stuff to get in and out of orbit, stuff like that. But separate from the engine block itself. So you like crack open the door and you find this like again it's like the air's very like your readings give like there is like just almost 100% nitrogen, basically. Nitrogen and carbon dioxide, that's all there is in the atmosphere. It's rather cold. I think Ryla, you have some understanding of post-tech stuff, right? So you know, right, the kind of shit this stuff is made of. You walk up and like, yeah, it's all of these things. The machines are currently off, which is not the ideal state for them to be.
Okay. I pointed a bay of buttons and I'm like, see all those buttons and lights? Well, they should all be sort of either green or cyan or anything other than the red that they are. And the ones that aren't even lit up.
Yeah,
well, some of them are bad.
There's like one red light, which is the able to be turned on light. It's like the thing your TV has of like standby, and that's the only LED that's on. And this bank of like switches and buttons and knobs and dials.
Can we press it?
Yeah, I mean, like it doesn't that doesn't respond. I'm afraid it's not that easy.
I sigh and say, right. I'm going to see if I can figure out if there's a... Can I tell if, like, the... Where are we exactly? We're on the bridge, yeah?
No, you've made your way down to kind of, like, sort of the reactor room.
Oh, right, okay, cool.
So you're, like, kind of standing underneath a heavily shielded nuclear reactor core. And, like, all these other fancy machines that keep... Yeah, I mean, like, it's safe to work in here because people do for extended periods of time. If this thing wasn't safe, no one would get out of this ship on the other end, like, heavily shielded. No one would get out of this ship the other end without, like, horrendous cancers. So, like, you're safe enough, unless the shielding has been compromised.
Which you wouldn't do to us, would you, Finbar?
How dare you say such a thing? I wouldn't possibly dream of waiting until you turn the life support back on and flooding the room with deadly radiation.
We're wearing vac suits, right? So that then we'll be fine. That's what Fallout has taught me, is if you just wear, like, hazmat suit, then you're completely fine.
I mean, I believe vac suits do offer a limited amount of protection from radiation. Not standing next to...
Why you guys argue over whether or not that's true? I'm going to quickly grab a drink.
Okay.
Kind of do need him to roll a thing. But yeah, so I think, yeah, like, so Ryla kind of sets about pulling up an axe panels and plugging cables together and da-da-da, trying to, like, figure a way to jumpstart this reactor. And we see Notos, like, yeah, we kind of flash back to, as everyone else is, like, leaving the briefing office, Eric said, Notos, hang back a moment. Something to mention to you. Those kind of file out. So, I take it Gideon had a peek in the case while you were flying back from Thrasmedes. So you've seen, and he kind of opens, like, pulls out one of those kind of, like, strange, it's about the size like a fountain pen. So you've seen these already.
Yeah.
Ever seen anything like it before?
No. Sadly not. No idea.
Fair. Never know. Psychic culture like the Avox, maybe you've come into contact with it, but... Okay. So, Sons of the Spike, they are rich in money, but they've got supporters from wealthy people on Thrasmedes. As much as that planet might be steeped in all of its conflicts, every now and again a wealthy business leader has a psychic child, and they need someone to look after her, because they're not willing to give her up to the government. And they get an influx of interesting technologies. And there's some good minds working there. This is one of their latest pieces. It's... like, it looks at Gideon, like... and, you know, the device appears to be amplify the... what is it? Meta-dimensional wave... energy waves within within the brain of a injected user. He, like... reached over and, like, slides his finger along the length of it. And the kind of top, like... shuffles out, like... slides off in that kind of very sci-fi way that where everything turns into panels from a smooth surface, reveals like almost an injector point, and then like the back bit like pops outside to becomes a button and goes inserting this needle into, and he kind of like indicates a few points on Eric into assorted like areas of the neck where the concentrations of nerves and such are will allow one to alter the way that metadimensional energies move around their brains. Amplifying for a short time, short time being the only amount that you could do safely, the psychic abilities of the user.
So I think psychic steroids.
Yeah, so he slides his finger back across it and is like, they're a one-shot thing apparently, something about need to be kind of put in a specific charger on a spaceship in Spike's... need to be in Spike space to charge back up again. Absorbing metadimensional energy from a normal space just doesn't do it very quickly. But here's the not-so-good news, and he taps a few buttons. This is the security footage that the Sons of the Spike managed to capture on a raid on one of their compounds very recently. You see, like, I think... so, like, armed troops wearing, like, quite strange-looking armor and these psychics fighting back, shooting... there's, like, some gunfire, occasionally like, something gets thrown at them, or, like, you see, one or two of them collapse, but you also see psychics, like, either getting shot or just, like, you see them, like, fall to their knees and, like, blood starts pouring out of their nose. Like, they were losing this battle a lot, according to my contacts, until this part. And it cuts, and you see, like, a blurry guy, like, holding what looks like one of these things, and, like, and then he, like, flicks his arms out and flips, like, a truck over, and then, like, pulls his hands down, a bunch of these, like, men collapse, and he proceeds to do some very awesome-looking telekinetic stuff, and he kind of goes, I guess you're there, like, well, that's pretty damn cool, you can see. Yeah. Cycle forward his 1 hour after the event, and like you see this like he goes, so this is the psychic in question, like gives put sort of photo of this kind of 28-year-old guy, looks pretty healthy, a little underfed. 1 hour after the event, and like he looks 50. His hair's like, he was a redhead, his hair's been shot through with grey, his eyes are sunken in, skin looks like it's gone to parchment, and it's like 3 hours later and after the event, and he's like, yeah, the guy's like expired, and like his flesh is shriveled up. It's like accelerated aging, massive blood vessel explosions in the brain. I mean, you've seen I presume you've heard of torching and the side effects of overusing psychic powers on a mass scale and in ways that we've not seen before. I don't know. They've tweaked and upgraded it since then, they claim, but they've yet to do any further in-the-field testing. They don't really get many of those opportunities when you're a terrorist group. He slides the thing a bit. Jace and the men he represents, they don't ask us to do nice things. last resort. If nothing else will work, Notos. You've proved yourself a few times in the field, and well, what can I do but trust one of my seven employees, huh? We'll keep studying, see if we can't iron out any further kinks. Hell, we don't even know what the kinks are yet. But
and Notos kind of looks at it as if he's just handed in death on a stick.
He kind of has. He's very much like, you shouldn't do this, but it's like, I think, yeah, you get Eric's, the kind of vibe he's given off is like, shit doesn't always go to plan. Sometimes we have to make bad choices. It's like, I think you just say, if it's death or this, well, you might survive. It's the best I've got.
Okay, this for use only in case of certain death.
This takes your chances from 0 to 10%. And that's the only time you should use it. Yeah, so he slides that across the table to you, and I think you... So do you take it?
Yeah.
Fair enough. So yeah, I think we, Yeah, I guess maybe there's, like, you pass, like, a room full of bodies, and Notos is kind of thinking about that. And then, yeah, Ryla, like, sits back up, like, slides out from under a console, goes, right! Yeah, Ryla, you think you've fixed it. You want to try hitting the on switch?
No, I don't. just to be difficult. Ryla says, well, this will either work or it'll blow up in my face, in which case I really hope none of you survive to see that. And he's like, there's like a button, and it's like he reaches to like really delicately push it, and then he just smashes his rifle butt into the button, and he's like, there we are.
Yeah, I think there's like a pause, like a pregnant moment. I'm pretty sure that's a phrase.
Yeah, that sounds like it's a
phrase. I have definitely read that in a...
What I would assume.
No. Pregnant as in, like, suspense of, like, the moment kind of dress. It's like, it feels longer, and it's like, everything's a little more tense. And then, yeah, there's a kind of a low hum, and the react, like, lights start turning on, react, like, you hear the cycles and the react start happening, And yeah, things start coming back on. It seems you've succeeded.
Fucking ace.
Lights start turning on. You hear, like, some of the doors resettling in there, like, as you kind of, like, cracked them a bit and then pulled them apart with physical strength enough to get yourselves through. And they're, like, either closing back with the automatic swish or actually opening. I think across, like, the speakers of your headset, you hear the sounds of, like, the... as the life support systems turn back on again.
Cool. I look at everyone expectant of some sort of gratification. The fact that I have just unfucked the situation somewhat.
Good job. Alright, can... Given that you could get out fairly quickly, you're skilled with your exosuit, can you cover, like, the door whilst I get out of my vac suit, assuming it is safe for...
I think your suit comes up with a little thing of, like, oxygen levels detected. Gives you, like, a...
Well, it probably replenishes the oxygen, doesn't it? Like,
yeah, I mean, the suit's, like, because the suit's tank's obviously very sealed. But, like, the little HUD, like, goes, like, air composition, like, yeah. Changes detected and shows you, like... I think there's, like, a little line where it says, like, when oxygen reaches this, like, the oxygen percent and then, like, safe levels to breathe. So yeah. Maybe it takes, like, a couple of minutes before enough, yeah. Like... cycles have happened that it gets back to breathable levels.
I say just hold up here whilst we wait for us to get up, and then we'll actually, given that it's a lot of time, if there's things on the ship, they'll know exactly where we are. The guy who can get out quickly, whose name is Ryla. Ryla, you should get out first, cover the door. Then Notos and I will get out of their arse suits.
Cool. I jump up. I jump out of my suit. I pull out the biggest. I pull out my spike thrower because we're in close combat. And yeah. Spike throwers can't pierce the hull of a ship at all.
No. Like most guns, Like, there is a layer of ship that they could probably get through, and then Bulkhead would slam close. If you kept shooting that, you've got maybe two chances. But, like, yeah, no, a spike thrower wouldn't get through the armor plating of a well-constructed ship, which this is.
Cool, so I...
You'd need something like a distortion cannon or a thunder cannon.
Well, I do something like that. I whip out some gear, and I'm like, right, get naked.
Cool. So yeah, you all
get sort of turns, slowly covering doors and getting changed.
Yeah,
nothing happens, I assume.
No, you're safe enough. Do you like do anything like? Because now the computer system's all back on. Everything's back on. In fact, like, what are you doing anything when you've got like a free moment, Ryla? To
When I'm not sort of covering these pansies, I'm gonna look for those black box recordings.
Yeah, so, do you mean like another computer role to get into like the new systems that you could feasibly access?
Cool.
Remember to change off chat,
I presume.
You do have a free 12.
As it's black box, yeah. So
yeah. Okay. So yeah, you flick it up. I think by luck, you open up. The first thing you get to is a.
Yeah. It comes up, it's like, restore to last default setting, and I click it open, and it's just like...
Yeah. So the first thing that opens is a camera window, and you see it's like, foreign body detected, and you see the shuttle on the side. The difference is, from the scene we saw just as it ended, we see that there are no people floating in spacesuits around it. And, the next like, alert goes, like, you flick it open, and it's like, hull breach detected, and you cuts like a camera feed of a corridor where I think it's you would recognize this of like one of these doors has been like pried open, and then over the doorway, like the gap into open space, like this kind of thing that's almost like a it looks kind of like a tarp, but it's like you would recognize it as a kind of like a piece of post tech that's like you use this on holes in your spaceship or like holes into vacuums for like, hey, shove this over it covers over the hole temporarily, and prevents like air travel.
It's a self-sealing skin. It amalgamates to the ship, and then it.
But this is like a portable version, generally used by people who've cracked their way into a ship, and then they turn around and go, so they can take. If there's life support on the ship, they can like stop all the air rushing out. So you know that immediately to mean there are people on this ship.
Cool.
At which point.
No, I tell people there are people on this ship. None of this at which point business.
Yeah, you get an access alert because you've managed to just basically go like you like basically tap a few buttons and you're in an admin account, and then it's like someone else has tripped a cyber alarm is there hacking into the system as well. And they aren't doing as good a job as you just did.
Hack off ensues.
Yeah. I mean, you can trace them.
Yeah,
computers. So then you get a camera feed of you see four people, like three of whom have kind of assault rifles, or combat rifles, and are wearing like they've taken the helmets of their exosuits off, but they're all moving pretty confidently around in them. And then there's a shorter person behind them. Like there's one of them's like 6'2", the other two are like 5'10" to 6 feet tall, and there's like 5'5" person behind them in a much smaller, like, and you can see like this girl has taken her exosuit off and she's like pulled off the gloves of her suit, just tapping away on a data pad, and you see her shit, and then looks towards the nearest camera and points, and one of the guys like swings towards it and like blows the camera out with his rifle. They're down in the cargo hold.
Cool. I turn to the guys I'm with, and I say, right. Well, turns out there's some fucking bastards down in a cargo hold who have got a shuttle attached to the side of the ship, and it's probably their fault that this whole place is a floating wreck. So
can't use grenades because it's in the cargo hold.
That's exactly what I just thought.
I can't solve my problems with grenades.
I didn't even think of that, but great.
Wait. Keep an eye on the cameras. We'll know where they are because the cameras which have been blown out are places where they are.
Yeah, or they just blow out all the cameras in the cargo hold and then move around freely, steal all the loot that we came here for. In the meantime,
We need to breach the cargo hold.
Yeah, so I'm going to go down there and do that. Is anyone else coming with me, or are you two still getting dressed?
Are we out? Yeah, I think you've got enough time to let you... I think maybe
I'm taking off
the leg of his suit.
I'm taking this out. Are you two done with your makeup, or are you, you know, do you need a moment?
At this point, Nagos is like, guys, we could get a shuttle.
A shuttle would be nice, yeah.
There we go.
Some incentive for the next
Man. Listened to my advice about, hey, maybe it's a good idea to look for other ways to get paid.
Yeah, so let's head down the... towards... Oh, we have the schematics, and we have the like advanced schematics of thing. Is there, like, for example, air ducts we can go through that are immediately people-sized?
Give me... who has navigation? Does anyone have navigation?
I have security.
Nah, this would require, like, you have a schematic, sure, and, like, I think...
I have zero in navigation.
Ryla has... Oh, yeah, that is having navigation as a skill, if you would like to roll that. This is no longer your free 12.
Wait, if 20. We roll this wrong, do we get lost in the ducks, or do we not?
No. It's just a case of, like, how much time they have to prepare. This would be wisdom, I think.
Six.
Yeah, no. You see a route that goes, like, down in there. Like, you could see a longer one that would get you, like, through some air ducts if you want to try and drop down from the ceiling or something crazy. But it's like, you're there with... You have access, root access to the system, so you can literally open all the doors along your route here, and then just sprint. So that's the fastest way to go. It'll give them, like, 15 minutes in there before you get down there.
Cool.
If we go the long route, it'll take 15 minutes.
No, so maybe so, like, just running there is going to take, like, 5 to 10 minutes. Just
that's
along,
a fucking,
like,
big ship.
I mean, it just doubles back on itself a lot. Like, the living quarters and all this jazz are designed to take up as little space as possible while cramming in a crew. And then there's this massive fuck-off, like, sequence of cargo holds.
I can run from one end of Nottingham campus to the other in, like, 5 minutes if I'm running.
Campus? Okay. Yeah, maybe it's a little... Yeah, I think it's still huge. 5 minutes, but then it's, like, it's not a straight line. Like, that's the thing. Like, you've got to run down some stairs, double round, run down some stairs... it's like this place is built for, like, tight corners and turns and all this jazz. You're not getting a straight sprint.
This isn't a frigate. This is something that was, like, designed, like, built as a civilian craft and has been modified the balls out of to make
it into. It is bigger than a modern day cargo ship. If it takes 5 minutes to get from one end to the other. Running.
Oh, it's less like, I'm not saying, like, it takes 5 minutes to, like, run end to end.
Yeah.
Like, because if you could run along the top, it would take maybe a minute and a half. Maybe not even that. If you're sprinting, it took less than that, probably. It's the thing of, like, you're following a map, you're, like, working your way around all
and
these
also,
awkward tight
I think
corners
also,
and turns.
As we're not using the, because I can't take the CCTV footage with me, and they've blown out the cameras, we're probably going to want to be moderately cautious,
yeah,
as opposed to just running around.
Yeah, so it's like, so maybe, yeah, okay, I'll give you that, yeah, it would be a thing of if you just sprint as fast as you fucking can, which I'll make you make athletics checks for, because as I say, going, like, down ladders, along, like, have you ever been inside a ship? You know, yes, I've been on board an aircraft carrier.
I have also been on ships, yes.
Fair, yeah, but, like, a military or kind of cargo one, it's not built for, like, there's a little more, like, kind of leeway on the health and safety of, like, you have these, like, near vertical staircases. So if you want to just sprint it, you could probably make it in 1 to 2 minutes. But if you want to actually, like, cover corners as you come around them and stuff like that, it will take five.
That works for me.
There we go. Compromise has been done.
We probably wouldn't be sneaky as considering two of us have sniper rifles.
I hope that's enough PJ salt for you, chat.
So much salt.
Yeah, so we have two sniper rifles, and we
have
me,
a D20 roll.
Me, who's super sneaky.
Yeah, I mean,
and
definitely get one person into a...
Could I, like, say, alright, you guys go normal route, I'm going to, like, because I'm also fast, can I sprint and run for the duct route that's much longer, but, like, attempt to get there fast?
Sure. Give me an athletics check, because, like, the thing is half it isn't running, it's the, like, commando crawling, but you are a trained soldier, so you probably...
I'm fast and dexterous.
You were trained in the warfare age where trenches were still a thing.
Yeah.
Is
this strength or dex? It didn't matter, but...
I think it's dex?
Based on your description,
I would say. Yeah, I think it's dex. What was that, Josh?
He was trained back in...
So he comes from a tech level 2 or 3 planet?
Yeah.
So he's a soldier from a planet that's in, like, originally in the American Civil War era of weaponry and technology. So he comes from, like, trench warfare times.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so yeah, you fucking leg it. The other two are being a little more cautious. Yeah, you find a route that gets you up on top of, like, a gantry, maybe. Give me a stealth check up there.
I'm good at those. Dex, I assume?
Yes. Yes, very much so. Thank God you got the life support on.
Yep.
Yeah, no, okay. Yeah, you, so you're creeping around,
This is my jam.
Yeah, and you guys, you get there shortly after he drops out of, like, a little duct onto the gantries above the storage deck, and, you, like, are you just...
Imagine we have, like, comms between each other.
Yeah, you all have phones and stuff, and in-ear comms, things like that. So you're all walking around like a bunch of Bluetooth headset dickwads.
Yeah. It's what I want. Just let me be that guy, okay? Because that's all I've ever wanted, was to be that dickhead.
I'm in position, I presume I have, like, shots on people and stuff.
I think at this point you just arrived and, like, you came in real quietly, like, you managed to lift the grate off and drop down. You barely made a sound. You didn't hear any, like, alerts. So you've not spotted them yet.
Okay.
And it's like you get there. You back up to a piece of cover so you're unseen from below. You pull your sniper rifle off your back.
I just have pistols.
Oh, you have pistols. Okay, so you're just, like, checking that, making sure, like, you're ready.
I'm gonna probably check. I'm in cargo hold. No, like, I'm in the cargo hold. No sight on them. What's your position?
Gentlemen, your position is you're just getting to, like, the doorway into the cargo hold at this moment.
Which I presume is still closed.
Yes.
With any sensibleness.
Yeah, I mean, there's a few entrances into the cargo hold across the ship. You're coming into, like, the closest one to you guys. Yeah, so, but, like, it should put you pretty close to Repsorb.
I don't suppose there's any chance you can get... No, all cameras have gone, aren't they?
Yeah, at this point, I think as you pull up, you're, like, if you managed to route it through onto your pad, and, like, yeah, all the camera feeds in the cargo hold are dead at this stage.
Can I hear anything?
Give me a perception check.
Beach?
Oh, I'm
great. This cargo hold's pretty, like, compared to, like, all the rest of the ships, which are very, like, twisty and, like, turny, this place is cavernous.
Yes, I'm attempting to pick up talking, so that sounds like a charisma roll to me.
Fuck off. Wisdom. That's good. Oh, but you are bad at that skill.
Yeah.
How high up is he, by the way?
Trying to think, like, because, yeah, we've gone from, like, they had about three, so you had kind of alpha deck, beta deck, Charlie deck, and then you had, like, delta deck is just this big fuck-off cave at the back, where all this stuff is, so it's, like, the height of three floors, a little cramped, so maybe, like, what, 10 feet each, I'll give it that, so machinery's got to be in there as well, so... Well, it's like 30 feet tall, something like that. So he's maybe like 20 feet up.
Cool.
Yeah, you don't hear anything on that one, I'm afraid. I'm afraid Repsorb.
Can I see where Johnny is now?
Not in the thing. Your door's closed.
Yes, I think maybe there's like a little like porthole or something, and you like scratch through and you're looking towards that door or something, Repsorb, and yeah, he spots you. Like...
So we can see Repsorb.
Yes.
Can I teleport to him?
Is that within your range?
Well, 30 feet is 9 meters.
Yeah, sure. You can like teleport onto like a box and teleport up onto like the gantry and then move to him. Sure. And I'll give you that as you don't have to take a single step on metal. I will just let you get that without a stealth check.
Cool. And then once I'm up there, can I make a perception roll? Because I'm less retarded.
So like the scene goes of just like you get there and like Ryla runs up and like like kind of looking, like wipes the condensation off of the like little porthole, backs up and is looking at his data panel, flipping through a bunch of like staticky camera feeds, and like Noto just kind of looks in, vanishes, and then like Repsol, you see him just appear on a box that appears on the gantry over, and then just appears next to you. It's like, hello.
Do you want to let us know next time you're going to do that? It's kind of freaky.
Okay. Give me a perception check then. Notice.
Which attribute?
Wisdom. So that's good for you. Yeah, okay. So you're like, as a bird species, I imagine you have very ridiculously keen eyesight. So you just pop your like beak over, sharpen, and yeah, about a good like, how big is this thing? Do we think?
Apparently, it's 5 minutes to an end.
5 minutes to move carefully. Fuck off. it's got to house like 25 people.
It was too easy.
It's got to house like 25 people in the non-cargo bits, and the cargo bits are the dominant part of the space. So it's going to be pretty large. Maybe like, I'm gonna say like 40 meters down this big like warehouse area. Yeah, filled with all manner of like crates, and like you see a few like covered things that kind of the furniture stuff that gets like the covers over it to make sure it doesn't get like all dust and shit on it. I swear less. Yeah, things like that scattered throughout this place. Do any of you have any idea what the SOC are about, by the way?
Well, I wouldn't have a clue.
I wouldn't have a clue either, probably.
No culture roles that help you there?
I've culture criminal or culture also, unless they're involved in either of those. They're...
I mean, culture criminal could kind of work.
Should I roll a culture criminal?
If you're interested.
Yeah. I've run into a lot of random people, so maybe I've met them.
Give me that culture criminal roll.
I have culture criminal. I have one in culture criminal. I'm fucking rolling.
Wow. Feel free to roll it.
I'm rolling with charisma, because I've met people.
Sure. Contacts and things like that. This would actually work.
11.
Okay. And what do you get, Ryland? Damn.
Is that a double six? Yeah.
These three rolls, guys. Bossing it.
Damn, gents. Alright, so yeah, you,
We're actually all honorary members. We just forgot to mention.
Yeah, no, like, you've probably run jobs for these guys. Ryla, you've definitely run jobs for these guys. I think maybe, a Repsorp, you've, like, maybe had a couple drinks with some people who've done it, like, but it was quite a standout story of they talked about the story where they were, because in all cases that you guys have heard of them or worked for them, you've been smuggling like artifacts or like stealing stuff from people or like protecting shipments of things or like hunting down thieves, and every time it's usually involved in some kind of like statue or antiquity, things that are rumored to be from Earth that was. Like, they're interested in pre-Scream stuff, but mostly if it's like, they get real, their jollies get real up for anything that's from Earth. And yeah, I think maybe, Repsol, you remember a story where like, some guy you were talking with was saying, yeah, I've fucking like, his crew snuck in the middle of the night and they attached like, kind of cables to the bottom. They went like some tech level 2 backwater, ran in, I was like, this statue they had up in the middle was from old Earth, they claimed. They ran in, they attached like little like devices to it, sped the ship over the top of it the next morning, and like the devices like latched cables on, like were targeting points for cables. They like fired the cables into the points, then pulled the statue out of the ground, just flew off with it as it like retracted into the... And like, he tells this great story of how he's basically like the most daring and amazing bit of flying he's ever done, and blah blah blah. Probably got beaten up by you later for referring to, like, said some very derogatory remark about how people from little backwater planets like that are savages. Stuff like that. But yeah, like, these guys, they're a big, like, company. They're based out of Veloka. And their thing is, like, the Society of Curators. And their thing is that they see themselves as the curators of old Earth society, of old Earth stuff.
And can we tell that these people are from that organization? Are they not?
I think, so, like, yeah, I mean, Notos can see, like, he's seen the logo, he's seen the logos on these boxes, and he sees them. And he cannot see, like, fucking 12, you can see, like, bits of, like, you can see, you can probably work out roughly when one of them, like, when the captain last shaved. And yeah, on their clothing, there's no, they're all, like, dressed in kind of drab stuff. They look a little, like, ragged and stuff like that, and there's no evidence of them being, like, they're, like, all in uniform or anything like that, and there's definitely no logos or anything like that on them. They're not, they don't seem like employees here.
So, are you saying that there's, I can see enough of them to take a shot?
Definitely, if you want to.
Are
any of them conveniently lined up?
What, as in, like, that you could shoot two of them in one go?
Yeah.
I don't think so, not, sorry.
Okay, I sort of, say, to, like, to Notos, like, alright, line up your shots, we get, let's get, whatchamacallit, in as well. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm awful at names. Ryla. Get Ryla in as well. If they make any motion that they seem to have heard something, we take the shots.
So I've kind of got my sniper rifle trailed.
Yeah.
The people at the moment.
We go to Ryla. Alright, bring yourself in. I think this is going to be a spike thrower jobby, probably.
Yeah, I mean...
It's out and locked and loaded. Like.
Yeah.
He's there's not taking...
This place is like lots of... like. The cargo is stacked up. Like, there's a bunch of it around there, I think, is all, like, their things. But they're also, like, carting stuff around for other people to cover the cost of the expedition. So there's, like, boxes everywhere of all different kinds. Some huge, like, water tank stuff in them along one side, one wall. All this kind of thing.
And then, I guess I'd probably motion Johnny to take up a different position. So he's got a different angle once... I fire.
Yeah, I think, yeah, it's like, you have a sniper rifle, like, shooting this with a pistol is definitely...
No, it's 40 meters away, right?
Yeah.
I range 100 meters.
Fair. It's feasible with your gun, because your gun's fucking amazing. Just saying, it's maybe not as ideal.
Yeah, but this, okay, I will move as, when it's moving as well, with Notos covering us both.
Yeah.
Yeah, with, like, and also make sure you stay, you're presumably lying prone, because I think that, does that give bonuses?
I mean, to get the good angle, he's definitely having to, like, jimmy around a bit.
For the aimed shot.
Yeah. Funny okay, shot. So Ryla, give me a stealth check.
No. Ryla, sort of...
I mean, you are, like, so I think you're about 50 meter flat run. Or 45-meter flat run to these guys. As soon as they come out this door.
Oh, right. Is it just, like, open space, no cover?
There's a lot of cover. Like, as long as you are okay with everything in here getting shot up.
Okay. In that case, if he's just going to run in, I'm going to stealth move to a different place first, then.
No. In which case, like, if I'm closer than that, then
if you run out, like, the thing is that, because they're up high, they have shots, but if, like, you just run in, then you will not be able to shoot them. And all you will do is announce that your group is around. Notice they are all like kind of crouched around, and you can't see her, but you can see the glow of the girl's like compad just off the like, around the side of like a big box.
So you're saying you can't shoot her?
Not at the moment, no. Not without like shooting through some cover.
That's my reposition move check.
Okay, yeah, you're good. Okay, let me...
A 7.
Because they are definitely looking for you guys. I'll do that. Oh, damn! Yeah, so, like, Repsorb, you're kind of creeping forward very slowly, and Ryla, you, like, wind down, open the door, push it open, and you're nearly out, and then it goes creak. Yeah, and you hear like a captain.
Can we immediately start shooting?
Because
we did say immediately as soon as we start.
No, they're going to look towards the door. They're not going to look up.
Yeah, I mean, no.
We can immediately start shooting in a surprise round, though.
You can if you're like. I mean, you're in transit. They don't immediately spot you, they just hear you. Like, you got an 11 to that 12, and he hears a noise.
Oh, it's a 12.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So that was a GM role. Yeah. He got a 12 on his perception, so yeah. Fair. Think of like, yeah, you hear this like voice in the other corner, "Hey!" And, like, in your scope, by the way, Notus, like, most of them vanish behind cover. And you see one guy leaning out a bit. So I mean, anyone talking, he's like, "Don't know who you lot are, but we're more than happy to split this. We ain't got enough cargo space for all of it. No one has to die here, gents."
So, just out of curiosity, what exactly are you here for? Like, this is like, I'm casually walking towards them at this point.
Yeah. Yeah, so I think, like, as soon as you pop, like, someone, like, pops out from cover and, like, a combat rifle is trained on you, and you see this, like, blonde, like, very large blonde man, like, looking down at scope at you.
So I do the same towards the blonde man.
Yeah, he doesn't know I'm he pops out of cover, and it's like, well,
I've got, like, a hand up, but, like, still obviously got a spike throw.
Yeah, it's like, one hand is off it, so it's like, I'm not immediately ready to shoot you, but I'm ready to shoot you. Shortly after, immediately.
Like, you'll shoot me, and then I will ruin your day.
Meanwhile, so Repsort, just so you have to know what you're doing here at the same time.
Can we get, like, a possible... I think a map would be very useful here.
That's a fair point.
I know you hate them.
Drawing. Okay.
Just boxy, though. Like, you can draw a boxy.
Yeah, so what we have is... Oh dear, I don't want a circle. Okay, so I'm just drawing the gantries. Okay. That's that bit. Slight move. Eeh. God damn my perfectionist habits. This is why I don't draw maps. It's because I want them all to look great, and I can't make them look great 90% of the time. And it makes me paranoid. So I'm just going to imagine that, like, underneath all these gantries, there's a shit ton of stuff. The important things are, so here there's... move in a sec. I'm just finishing off their, like, little circle they've built for themselves. And I need to change colour for these guys. So there's one there. There's one there. The girl's, like, somewhere here. And, those are the ones you can see. And then I'm going to say Notos is back here.
Why can't I see the map?
You will be in a moment. I'm working on that. And then, okay, so... And I will pull the audience in. There we go. A map. So, put some text on to make life a little easier. Text. So, in my head, this is Notos with a sniper rifle. This is Repsorp.
Yep.
This is Ryla.
Hold on, I need to zoom out.
This is the blonde guy. You saw him get referred to as Vasily. And then this is the captain, who's talking currently.
Cool. Yeah, I slow down till I'm like...
Yeah, the third dot is where you presume the girl with the compact to be. That's roughly the layout. There's a shit ton of boxes all over the bottom, but I can't be asked drawing a bajillion boxes.
Yeah, cool.
Repsorb, you're kind of creeping, and, like, you haven't been noticed yet, but you probably, like, very much looking in the same direction as where you are.
I just stay prone and just train guns on them.
Okay. Yeah.
Make sure I do still have a grenade on ready.
Yeah. There's a grenade ready if things go bad.
Yeah.
The guy is like, just trying to make a living out here in space like the rest of you. I assume you ain't with the SOC.
No.
Check that they aren't either.
Our little friend Aiko here noted your ship doesn't exactly carry any of their authorization codes, or indeed any authorization codes you could find.
Ah, so you've been scanning us.
Well, we protect ourselves from a scan first. Smugglers don't like to be found.
Yeah, no, I know exactly what you mean. We're pretty much the same boat as you. So,
literally and figuratively.
I like...
that just comes over the comms.
I smile to myself, but like no one else can hear it. I'm like, you guys are missing some great puns.
Where's the rest of your crew? Presuming it's not just you.
They're around, generally keeping an eye on things, like making their way to your ship, just to make sure there's none of you sneaking up behind us. You know how it is.
Okay. Kind of looks at you a little warily.
Look, we're here for something in particular. If you don't mind, we want to look around. I'll call my crew down. We'll look for this particular thing. And then, yeah, we'll split the profits pretty evenly. Sound fair?
The rest of the crew won't come down. You'll find it yourself. We'll keep you covered.
You'll keep me covered? No, I don't need covering.
He's like, I presume that's your crew on the other end of the comms then. He's kind of like, okay, we do this way. I'll step out, nice and slow-like. And then one of your crew will step out nice and slow-like. Then my friend Vasily here step out nice and slow-like. And
I tell you what.
We'll all just have a nice little conversation, put our guns down,
people. I pull out a grenade and I pull the pin out holding the fucking hammer in place. And I say,
yeah, Vasily snaps up.
Yeah. I say, how about you shoot me and I blow a hole in this cargo hold, and then all my mates that are back at your ship laugh as you guys get flushed out of the void. Because if you shoot me, quite frankly, I'm dead anyway, so what do I care if I take all of you pricks with me? Now, how about we have a nice, civilized conversation?
Yes, that's what's like, this is my school of negotiation, I like it.
Give me a persuasion check to override one of them trying to go like, well, I don't know if a frag grenade could pierce the walls, but... Because do any of you know whether a frag grenade could pierce the hull of a ship like this?
It would pierce the cargo hold, but it wouldn't pierce... Because this isn't, you've got to remember, this isn't a proper freighter, so it doesn't have, this is a civilian issue ship that's been modified.
Yeah, so, there's still occasionally, like, safety measures in play. I'm just thinking, like, because this thing, you don't know spaceships.
Falconets do only have, like, a 10 radius.
I do, I know spaceships, that's one of the things I've got.
It's, you know how to fly a spaceship, it's like the same thing of, do you know how to drive a car? Because you know to drive a car, do you know how much force the wall of a car can take?
I have vehicle space.
Yeah, that's a driving, that's like a moving the thing around skill, whereas like aeronautics is like able to build a spaceship.
Could probably roll a thing.
Yeah, I'd say you could give it a go, but I think I'd bump the difficulty a little bit. Because it's like, vehicle space is the ability to like move a spaceship where you want it to go and like fly around in a dogfight. Whereas, or land in a horrifically unpleasant place. Whereas, like, aeronautics is able to just go, like, okay, this is how much force the wall of a ship can take. That's the thing of, like, there's a good chance you get through it.
Hey, Fimba.
I rolled an 8 for persuade.
Okay. How much strength do you reckon it would take to move that box in front of them?
Do you have complex manipulation? Or the one that gives you 18 strength? You could definitely do it with 18 strength.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, 18 strength is borderline superhuman. Like that is world's strongest man territory of stuff you can move. Because, yeah, you're stretching the limitations of what it means to be a human being at 18 strength. How much does it cost to activate a level 2 power?
Or is it 2.3.
Which is like your entire pool.
I have 5.
Oh, okay. But you lost some for mastering teleportation.
Yeah, I used those ones.
Oh, okay. Oh,
you gain 4 at level 2, and I had 6. So no, I have 4.
Okay, cool. That's cool. Alright, yeah, so he like goes, okay. And you see a hand like slows down, puts his combat rifle on the ground, it's like, hold your horses there, buddy. Hands up, he like comes out and says, the name's Ravi. Who do I have the pleasure of addressing?
My name's Ryla, and I put the pin back in the grenade, and I put it away. Like, I give him a wave as I put the grenade away. I'm like, sorry, it's just, you meet some really uncivilized people out here on the edge of space.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, I don't suppose you guys know exactly what happened on board, or was that you?
No idea. Got here. Few hours before you did. been working on scavenging some plates on getting in the ship. Whatever we can get that'll work out. Freight like this, worth a chunk of money.
Do you want a hand with anything?
He gives you a look. It's like, I'd appreciate it if there weren't men in the dark pointing guns at me. That's a nice start. It makes my friend Vasily here very nervous.
And you're telling me that you don't have anyone thinking about pointing a gun at me? Look, we're just business.
It's like you could still see, at this point, you could still see Vasily looking quite like as long as like looking a little shifty. It's like, how about this? How many friends you got on this ship?
Six. I've got enough to take you.
Always give a number.
He sighs. It's like, God. No polite. You don't find any politeness in the modern day career criminal. Whatever, man. What are you looking for?
I said we're looking for a. What was the description of it? It was a
box. Yeah, like quite high tech looking. The serial number is 347-1Z2N.
I recite that to him and say, we're looking for this.
But we also want a couple of extras.
Yeah. Oh, and pretty much like half the loot, essentially.
The man like just like, fella, I ain't even going to be able to carry a tenth of the loot here. Our ship's not much bigger than your own. We were having a little look around to see what was actually worth any money when you guys switched the power back on.
You're welcome, by the way.
Thank you. Saved us some legwork. Switch on the security systems, though, which caused Akko here no problem.
I just realised we were massive idiots. As soon as we saw they were taking the vac suits off, we should have immediately turned the life support off again.
You've just taken your vac suit off. It had taken you, like, 10 minutes.
All they did was pop helmets, because they're all capable of moving in them.
Of course, yeah.
And also thing of, like, if you turn the life support off, just slowly cycles the air away.
Fair.
It's like, to get rid of them, you'd have flush it.
I could have purged the section, but by the time I'd done that, they would have got it back on. Because they took was like their hands, their gloves and stuff like that. So
yeah.
I considered that at the time and then was like, nah, that's just too much.
Also, like, opening the cargo doors out to the vacuum of space might not be great when you want a thing in the cargo hold. but yeah, so it's like, Akko, see if you can hunt down this fella's box.
I give her a wink, I say.
Yeah, like, she is not coming out from behind this thing. You get this very high-pitched voice come out, it's like, belonging to, like, a, like, I don't know, like, if you can tell the difference, there's, like, a Japanese accent on it, and she goes, and also, like, sounds, like, quite young, female, and, yeah, I think she actually says it in Japanese. Do any of you speak Japanese?
No.
This is a thing that you could do. No, you speak Dutch and English, and you speak. I forget what you speak, rather.
I speak a lot of. I speak enough to get me laid in several languages. That's
good, good. But you do get access to some extra languages from like your home planet and stuff like that.
Yeah, no, but most of it is just I know enough to get me laid.
Okay, fair. You hear like a string of Japanese in this quite high pitched accent.
Can I tell if she's got?
I don't know. I don't think so.
What do I roll? Just give me a roll.
Deception, shit.
Luck save.
Yeah, luck save. Because you're gonna say she sounds hot either way, so the luck save is whether you're right or not.
Success.
Boom!
Boom, yeah.
18. She's hot.
Yeah.
She's 18. Brilliant.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, so you get, like, some... He's like, alright. Akko says... Kind of points over to the other side of that, like... opposite side, and goes... so if I'm showing you on the map... about here? It's like... over there? Kind of points towards, like, this vault thing that's built in the secure storage location.
Cool, that sounds brilliant. Can you go ahead and not shoot me while I go loot that, and then... like, I'll help you divvy up some stuff and carry it back to the ship, and we all can crack open some bubbly later or whatever, and Akko, me and you need to have a chat. And I head
string
over to...
string of Japanese.
Does it sound like I'm doing well?
Yeah, I think, like, Ravi puts his hand on and says, Can we all agree to come down here face to face, put all the guns away? Honestly, when Vasily's getting very anxious, and I don't particularly like putting all my crew through this for entire... We're not trying to fuck you over. So we'll just stop pointing guns at each other.
Okay.
If your crew stands down, mine will stand down. We can do this like civilized people.
Okay, I just come over to the comms and I say, right, I've forgotten your two names.
They are Notos and Repsop.
Okay, so Notos, Repsop, come down. Mal, Vichenko, Vasily, Desny, you can all stand down and do me a favor, just go back to the ship. Oh, and tell everyone on board to just chill the fuck out and... No worries.
Notos, Rabi kind of motions like his hand a bit, and this guy you hadn't seen yet, well, you had seen him on the camera feed, but he wasn't there, kind of walks out, like, holding a, what's he armed with? He doesn't have a combat rifle, I don't think. Yeah, he's holding, like, a semi-automatic pistol, kind of walks out, puts it down next to his captain's, rifle, and, like, stands next to the captain.
Cool.
And they wait for you to like display your next person.
Yep. I'm going to
How about you teleport walk... down? What could make them uncomfortable? Teleporting.
If a bird teleported there, I was like, "Kaka!"
There's no toss, it's just kinda like, well, two of them are unarmed.
I'm gonna holster pistol nice and just walk along here and then drop down like on top of the containers they're at.
Okay.
Just like casually.
Yeah, one of the like Vasily looks up and like moves to cover you. And you kind of drop down, holster, and he goes, Vasily.
Vasily, I just go to sit like literally on the container she's taking cover on. Just like, hey.
Yeah. Vasily like kind of looks up at you, and he like holds the rifle up, snaps the safety onto it, and puts on his back and stands up. Ravi looks towards you. Anyone else?
Notos is like, are we really not going to take advantage of the situation?
Everyone else is going back to the ship, so don't worry.
Notos, it's all you, baby. What do you do?
Feel free to set things to go crazy if you would like.
That is out of character, I presume, is what you're saying, as opposed to standing in front of us going, you can make things crazy if you want to.
I nod and I'm going to head over and start unlocking this secure... Well, yeah. We're going to take a look at it, at the very least.
I want to see what Notos does, I think, because there's still an element of, like, everyone is close to their guns still. So there is an element of, like, if someone does something random.
Yeah.
So Notos, what do you do? Like, there are three people very much standing in, like, sniper rifle, like, openly. So you could very easily start tapping some fools.
Especially as you get auto hits as well, don't you?
With the take aim thing, I don't think. No, it's they have to make.
They make a check or they die instantly.
Yeah, you can like ignore.
But I do have the D20 dice thing.
Yeah, you do. You do basically have
so
like
first
so.
Shot is
so clear. I think maybe it's like it's like you have had a crosshair following someone for this entire thing. Yeah, you could very easily just go and tap someone out in the first like just dead.
We can make a convincing entrance into this battle. That's what we're saying.
Yeah. It's then like, are your buddies ready to go quick draw and are they faster than these guys?
Yeah, Notos is just kind of like, guys, should I fire or show up? Just say the word.
Just like...
I mean, you're the ones likely to get shot at.
Yeah.
I'm walking over to this thing and having a look at it to see what it is.
I mean, Ravi did ask you, like, very directly, Ryla, like, anyone else.
Yeah,
So you just don't answer and just wander off.
Yeah, no, I said no. I said no, because I forgot he was there, to be completely honest.
Fair enough. I feel I should make you make a deception check or something. Ryla's...
If he genuinely forgot he was being covered by a spy.
100%, like, I... Like,
so
not,
brave.
It's not deception, because he believed it.
We see him pivot on one heel, start striding off, and pulls, like, a hip flask and takes a swig.
Yeah, and he just like goes over, takes a drink, and sees what he can do to crack this bitch open.
Yeah, so you're wandering over, so no toast, like. Make your call. What would.
I'm chatting away, like. No, we're a fairly small crew actually, but pretty effective, surprisingly.
Yeah. Oh, so you can actually see, from your position where you are, you can see Akko, who's, this, like, 18-year-old, like, I'd say, like, maybe half Japanese.
If you kill the one bonable person on this ship, yeah. I will kill you myself.
Hey, I'm super bonable. I'm so hot.
She's very pretty, kind of petite. She's generally, like, kind of, yeah, so. But we're not going to get into me describing a pretty woman, because that'd be weird.
Okay, Notos lays his mag rifle next to him.
The sniper rifle?
No, the mag, his okay. other gun.
Okay.
And he's like...
Take the shot. Do it.
He hears the whisper of that.
That's through the meta-dimensional spike waves.
Right.
Who's the one, so right, any of them that I can see still armed without
their I think Vasily put the safe gun in his rifle and put it, like, in, like, kind of shouldered it, but that's still, like, he could probably get that back up again in the same amount of time it takes, Repsol to draw, like, as they specifically are standing off. He put himself as at much of a disadvantage as Repsol did, and no more. You can't see Akko. She has like a pistol on her hip, but yeah, you can't see that. The captain has a laser pistol at his hip, but he has put his rifle down. A guy next to him has no other weapons.
Okay, I shoot the guy.
I've put like my spike thrower down, but just so you guys know, I'm still carrying a mag rifle, grenades, and a sniper rifle.
Okay, I shoot the guy with the holstered rifle.
Okay, so you get an insta crit. So roll damage for me.
That would be 2d8.
Let me just check how much HP. So this guy has that, and his physical effect save is that. And he's got to make a physical effect save at a minus...
No, he gets plus one, because I've only got minus one with projectiles.
Oh, is it... okay, right, I see, yeah.
I assume that's how it would work.
Yeah, so slash R space 1, d20.
And you know, I've got polar opposite, so he hits for 9.
Okay, so he gets 1d20 plus 1. But he fucks it! So yeah, just as you're like going, hey, how's it going? And this guy just like, head snaps... And he collapses like a puppet with its strings cut. Roll initiative.
Do we get a I'm taking the shot to give us a plus one on initiative? Maybe, Mr. Sniper, or do we?
So that's and everyone just like spins and Akko just is like shocked. The
how
captain
do you roll
the
initiative
reaches.
Again?
So it's 1d8 plus your dex modifier.
So not
But actually what we'll do is we will cut to break now as this guy collapses, and when we come back we'll have sort initiative and we're ready to go. With you.
You guys look like you've got a button.
Just a moment.
Yeah, there is one.
Thank you all for being here, you wonderful people. We shall return very shortly to play some more wild cards, which is going to be blue, and also our initiative, so you don't have to watch me do that. And yeah, for the final hour of this week, don't go anywhere. It's going to be cool. If you haven't followed the channel already, please do hit that follow button. Again, you can find all of our social media, donation rules, YouTube channel, and all that other nonsense down in the panels below the stream, and you can watch all the stuff we've done previously. It's great. Go do all these things. See you in a moment. Hello and welcome back to week 4 of Wildcards, part the third. The final hour of this week. So, Notos just shot a man right in the head, snapped his medulla, if you've watched the latest Mad Max. I should change these up. So the captain... Oh, damn it. I really should have moved these onto a different layer. But oh well, I'm a bad person. So bite me. Give me a fucking... There we go. So that's the captain. I'll just do this. So the captain and this dude are standing right next to each other. Come on, you piece of... I hate the grid. It's terrible. That'll do.
Turn off the grid.
I did. Okay, so Adam apparently has reflexes like a fucking cat. So he runs, spins on a heel... turns around and runs and snatches up his pistol. And I think just straight up... I'm gonna give him an athletics check because he just like runs to grab Akko and run behind this thing away from you all. Just see whether he can like carry this girl off with him, as it were. /r/2d6... And he has no... He's at a minus one. He's a minus one for athletics. Check this guy. This is not his deal. But yeah, he just grabs her and bundles, and him and... So Alex and Akko do manage to successfully leg it behind a new piece of cover. God damn it. Okay. So this one's Akko. I both leg it behind this piece of cover.
Cool. Vasily is dead, then.
Vasily, yeah. He just collapses, like a puppet with a strings cut. Notos.
Right, so where exactly is everyone?
Captain is here.
Yeah.
Like in good view of you. The other two have moved to where they think they aren't in range. I think maybe you can see Akko poking out.
Is Akko the check?
Yes. So you can see, yeah, this like streak of black hair as opposed to the brown haired guy who ran in there. So you can see, like, just about see her, but it's not a great shot. Whereas the captain is, like, right fucking there. Vasily's dead. Repsorp is on top of that, like, container and is moving to, like, going for his gun. Ryla is, likewise, had forgotten you existed. So was wandering off. It's like, oh, shit. The spike rifle, or, like, maybe running for his spike throw or whatever. I don't know what he's going to do, but, yeah. Is reacting slowly. So, yeah, what do you do?
Okay, I'm going to... take a shot at the captain.
Okay.
So this is going to go less well.
Probably. Let me remind myself of his AC. Oh, his AC is 5, apparently.
So what do I roll again?
So if you go into your character sheet, there should be a button next to the line that says sniper rifle.
Yep.
If you've put in the sniper rifle, you just click that.
AC 5.
Yep.
I use dex for it, so 1.
Yep.
No other modifiers.
Yeah, you have, well, you have minus 1 for your skill with the weapon.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I should have just put 0 on everything. Oh well.
Yeah.
I missed.
Ah, damn. That's close. But yeah, so you're like quickly readjust and pull the trigger, but he's already moving. So it's like just that's under it. So Repsorp,
rolls on top of the container to put myself into cover on the container, basically.
I mean, you can just roll off the side and suddenly you're, like, doing okay.
basically, I'm just lying on top of the container.
It's probably, like, a box, like, so you just jumped onto, like, the stack of boxes and just jump off of one of them, so you've got now a box beside you, on one side at least.
I mean, just being prone on top of a container. I just keep height, because, like, height is impossible to deal with, basically, because...
Yeah, fair enough.
Basically my head exposed and nothing else, and then I'm just going to pop some shots off at the captain.
Okay. AC 5.
Okay.
I can't check chat at the moment because I'd then put the stream on the stream and that always goes weird.
AC 5.
Look into the endless abyss.
Attribute modifier 1. Other modifiers 0.
Damn.
Yeah.
Woo! Yep, that is a hit.
Who'd you shoot at?
The captain.
Nice.
Yeah, so yeah, that tree is, you pop a shot and it whacks him in the, like, he ducks out the way of the sniper shot and you're already leading the target, and, yeah, you put a shot in the back of his head and he collapses. So he's a dead man. Okay, Ryla.
Cool. Ryla's sort of pissed off that this has actually turned into a fight and he's going to just turn around. And where's what's her face?
Well, you saw Alex, the other guy, like, run around the back of the thing, and maybe a yelp of surprise. So, I mean, you don't exactly know, but they can't have gotten far.
I'm going to come around the corner with my spike thrower up.
So, like, to here? Sorry, I should be on the map.
Let me drop onto the map, yeah. To there.
Okay. What I should really do. To there. Okay. Yeah. So,
cool.
You get round and, yeah, you see Alex, like, kind of half out of cover. And, yeah. Adam, not Alex. I think moving that far probably uses up, like, the majority of a turn. Do you say anything? Do anything else? Like, unless you want to just try and blow a chunk at, like, while they shoot.
Oh, I want to kill him. I just don't want to kill her.
Oh, good.
A spike, though, is not necessarily the best weapon to use.
Yeah, I'm not that. It's like, it's just like, if it's possible, but I'm just going to...
An attack roll. You are going up against... He has an AC of 7, but he definitely gets some plus from this being around this container. AC 4. Because he's hiding as opposed to waiting to shoot you.
Oh, very close.
Yeah, like you pump the thing and then just, I know I had to flick it up. Okay. Just fast switch it. Pump the thing and just, like, blast a chunk out of the side of this box, and he, like, ducks around and you hear, like, both of them yell. Kind of fear.
What was her name, sorry?
Akko.
Echo. I yell, like, sorry, Echo! And then, like, I'm totally gonna keep shooting.
Yeah, I think on her turn, Echo just, like, you see a gun just, like, gets tossed out the side. It's like, will you give up? Got no interest in dying here. I can't beat you. So, just, yeah, like, I think on Adam's turn, his gun follows the same. It's like, they both just surrender. They have no fucking chance. Notos. You can just see, like, a bit of Akko's hair poking out of the back of this box, so, like, you can adjust for that and feasibly shoot through the cargo crate.
No, Notos hoists sniper and just teleports to the floor below and begins walking towards them.
So we get the nice clack of talons on, unless, do your people have shoes? Because I imagine shoes are a weird thing for a bird people.
No, I don't think we would.
Yeah, so, like, you just hear the clack of talons against the metal flooring. Like, along the rubber and plastic bits that, like, walkways that run through the stuff. Repsol.
I'm just gonna run and jump across to the other container. Well, or, like, and just run across and just be basically on top of them. And go back to sitting on top of the container. Hi!
Yeah, I think they both look up and, like, oh! Don't, and, like, Adam's like, don't fucking kill us!
Right. Sorry about that. Our sniper's a little bit trigger happy.
Trust issues. Ryla? You all kind of, like, converge. Like, Repsol and Ryla, you're obviously closer, but Notos is blinking his way across the room up to you.
Cool. I walk over to Akko and I'm like,
I mean, Adam is also still alive, just so we are all clear.
Yeah, and he is suddenly aware that no one cares that he's still alive. And
I'm watching Adam.
Yeah, they're like
professional.
They're like huddled next to each other, like, what the fuck? What the fuck? What's wrong with these people?
I say, look, I'm really, really sorry about that. That wasn't actually my idea. I wanted this all to be peaceful. He had other ideas. You understand. Look, essentially, why don't we just chill out? We're gonna grab what's in here. You guys are going to come with us back to our ship. Echo, you can have my personal quarters for this evening. I imagine I don't have personal quarters. I'm making this bollocks up.
But you all have, a room. Yeah, there's... There are rooms aboard the Texas Ranger. It's big enough to house... I think you could feasibly double bunk people, but you'd be real cutting into their life support. But the idea is it's a long haul thing. You have a crew. So yeah, there's rooms to put you all up.
Cool. I say, you can have my personal quarters and have a drink with me. Got some sake on heat.
Come over. This is not the time to be flirting.
I mean, you're close talking. Enough that you can just talk to each other. Give me a persuasion. Yeah, give me a persuasion. See if you can in any way calm this girl down. if you can just or even Adam to that respect of where hey, yeah, we aren't gonna kill you. Breathe, because I mean they've already seen you say we're not gonna kill you, and then one of their friends got his medulla snapped. Another one got some metallic spikes thrown through his skull. Captain Ravi ain't doing so hot.
Hold on one second. Whoa. Why's half my screen died?
Okay, that's not good.
Nope. I can't see half my screen. That's worrying.
That's usually not great.
Including my character sheet, which is really annoying. That's not my character sheet. Where's my character sheet? Can someone roll it for me? Finbar, can you roll it
for
me?
Sure. What am I rolling for you, sorry, again? Persuasion, that's it.
No, you asked me to roll it, I don't know.
Persuade. Imp. Attribute. Charisma. Submit. Assisted. Submit.
I really want him to roll a 12 and just straight up seduce this chick.
They both relax. Okay, looks you Yeah, because I guess you wander around you didn't mean to hurt her friends. You fired a warning shot, right?
Yeah.
You were just hey, don't do anything stupid. Let's all breathe here.
You look
cut a pretty, dashing figure as the person not sniper, who hasn't killed any of her friends.
I've got the shotgun slung over my shoulder, and I look at her, and I'm like, sorry, babe, sometimes it just goes off in my hand without warning. Anyway, we're gonna go and fix the...
Notice
this point cuts and it goes, she had a compad. Take it, someone.
I mean, you're there too, and she's she whirls around, she kind of, I think she looks down at it as if having completely forgotten it existed. This girl's evidently not battle trained. Does one of you just drop down and take it off her?
Yeah, I'll drop down.
I gesture for her to come over to me, and I take it off her, chuck it to one of the guys as I put my arm around her, and I'm wandering over to where we need to go.
Okay. Oh, you're so creepy.
Dude, that's a bit rapey.
It's kind of creepy.
That's literally the words that come out of Repsol's mouth. It's just
I think Guy Adam kind of is slowly getting to his feet, and he's like, can I put my hands down?
Yeah, chill, dude. It's fine.
And then so Adam, how many people on your ship?
Turns to you as, what? Just one. Pilot.
I'm going to roll... What would I roll to see if he's telling the truth?
I think... Is there an insight skill in this game?
I don't know, it's a skill list.
I think it's just all falls under perception. So yeah, you can try and perceive.
Would it be perception with charisma instead of...
I'd say wisdom.
Oh, with wisdom? Okay.
Yeah.
7.
Yeah, he's telling the truth. He's too fucking scared of you all to lie to you.
Cool.
Seconds, you carved up the security portion of their team.
Yeah.
I think you get the read off this guy that he's not, from the fact that both of the other two carried, a rifle and a sidearm, and this guy's just carrying, a semi-automatic, and she's, a young girl who's really... Neither of them are holding their cool in this situation at all. Both of them were round cover and were not the people pointing guns at you. These guys are the support team here to, they're the experts. of this crew.
Alright, so here's what's going to happen, guys. You're going to help us identify everything here and find out what's valuable. We're going to take your shuttle, put it back on our ship. Then we're going to leave you here, and your ship's going to come pick you up. And then we're all good.
I'm looking at Akko this whole time. I'm like...
Yeah, it's like, okay. Goro's expecting a call in from us in like an hour.
Svet, feel free to call him and tell him the exact situation. Like, we have like no qualms about it. When call in comes time, like, okay. As long as he doesn't do anything to disturb us, we won't do anything to disturb you.
Okay.
Other than the unfortunate incident that has just occurred, but we can all move on from this, and yeah, you can still get your own share of salvage after we've gone.
Okay.
Sure. This is still a profitable job for everyone involved, remember?
Apart from the people who would... Why did we kill them? Like, turning to Nosos.
I look at you like, I don't know. I didn't shoot anyone.
Yeah. I shot because he shot and assumed we needed more shooting. Why did you shoot?
Nosos just points at the shuttle.
You wanted the shuttle, didn't you?
Shiny.
He's a fucking magpie. I'm telling you. Sorry, is that racist? Is that, sorry, I shouldn't have said that. That's racist, isn't it? Oh, fuck me. I'm sorry.
So Ryla, you escort Akko over towards, the like, security vault that your apparent cargo is inside. And, yeah, it's, like, some decent security just on the door.
Cool.
You see this kind of, like, interesting, this, like, vault-looking thing. What do you do? There's, like, there's a kind of, like, made out of, like, some kind of, like, blackened surface. It feels pretty cool to the touch. Maybe, some kind of metal. I don't know if you can necessarily tell what metal is by touching it. There's a door built into it, no windows in the door, just a slit and then a keypad on the side.
Cool. I'm going to see, like, can I discern, like, how this is opened? Like, is it a keypad?
There's like a keypad. I think there is also a keycard slider.
Cool. I look at a keycard slider and I say, do you mind giving me a hand with this, Akko? Because the sooner we're out of here, the sooner we can get you that drink.
Like, every mention of, like, flirting, it's, like, just face-palming from Repsol, which is, oh, God.
Yeah, I love the fact, though, that I'm the one who's, like, I've made things work. I've made things work with these guys. You guys fucked things up, okay? We were getting along perfectly fine.
As this is all going on, Notos begins looting the bodies.
Oh, God.
Okay, we'll get to that in a minute. Okay, so yeah, you start, she, like, crouches down, she starts, cracking open the thing, she pulls out, like, she kind of, I need a comm pad or a date pad, some interface device.
I hand it back to her, and I pull out, I got some cool I've got a meta tool, which is, helpful.
You pull out your meta tool. Use the line, he pulls out his meta tool.
While you're down, love,
Oh dear God!
Meta tool. Why are you? I know they're so bad.
Hi, man. Okay. Yeah. She like kind of looks a little bit like. Again, it's very much. She's a little shell shocked. So she's kind of doing things a little slowly and not really perceiving the innuendo. But she takes her data pad and she like hooks up some cables into the I think maybe it's like a specific, you know, that card, the fake card they use in Terminator 2. It's like some kind of high tech version of that.
Yeah.
Fits into like the card slot, and she starts tapping away. And yeah, she's better than you at computer stuff. Like a lot better.
Cool.
Like she's in this context, she's as good as you when she's surrounded by four people she doesn't know. Adrenaline's pumping through her system, and she's like borderline going into shock.
Right, she's like
three people. Three people. I just presume normal party size. Sorry, but yeah, like in a state where she should be like shaking and completely not useful, she's as good as you are at this.
Yeah.
Other than that, she's an adrenaline junkie. Yeah, a few minutes later, she's like, "Okay, system should be cracked. Wanna do the honors?" Of the rest of you, like gathered up at this stage.
Yeah, I'm looting the body.
I know you. Oh, you're looting. I'll tell you what you get later. But you have finished doing that. The time it takes her to crack the security on this thing.
Yeah, I'm just hanging around with Adam.
Okay.
I'm chatting smuggler stuff with him.
Okay.
And profusely apologizing.
Well, Notice just kind of stalks around, looking at all these things.
Cool.
I'm trying to sell him on how this is a good thing. Like, so the captain's been taken out of the thing now, and let's face it, she's not up to leadership thing. That puts you in charge right now. So this job, you're gonna get a bigger cut out of this now. Right? So this is actually, it's all you're planning to backstab him anyway, weren't you? I mean, everyone's always planning to backstab their boss.
Everybody hates their boss.
Yeah. So like in reality, and like here this heavy to keep you in control, but like now is your chance. Now you have control of your group. And I'm just generally trying to sell him on
yeah, okay.
Not hating us.
Yeah, one second. I'm just looking up some other things.
Like how few shits he gives about what you have to say.
Yeah, probably.
Probably.
How close their relationships were.
I am very charismatic.
Okay. Oh, these don't really work very well. That's frustrating. Okay.
Should I make some kind of roll for making?
No. That's just small talk you're making. I don't think you're really going to convince this guy how great it is that just two of his friends got murdered.
That seems fair.
But yeah, so you wander over as Ryla hits the open door button. The doors slide open, and I think the first instance we get of this is Notos. Sort of those feelings of when you first discovered and like first were training with psychic energies. That feel of like it's kind of like it feels like the smell of ozone in your brain. Like this room is filled with metadimensional bullshit. And it crackles out, and
you all
stagger back, and so like the firstly thing that happens is around you, like you hear a scream, like Notos, you're like your head is like swimming, it's like this like crackle and like there's like a high pitched noise in your ears, and, like bright lights like spots in your eyes for everyone. You're stepping back. And notice, like, the, like, air, you look up and, like, around you, boxes are, like, accumulating frost. And, yeah, like, you witness everything's, like, rapidly cooling. Repsorp, as your vision clears, first of all, you see Adam has collapsed and is, like, screaming on the floor, clutching himself. And, like, he started to bleed from his nose. And as you look up, you see, like, maybe there's a sign or a box or something that said, like, danger, or, like, fragile, this way up, and you can't read. The letters are physically changing shape in front of your eyes.
Good.
And, Ryla, you, like, shake it off, but, you get this weird little buzz in the back of your head, but you feel mostly fine at the moment. Akko next to you seems, like, about the same place, and, like, she was in this epicenter of it with you, or, like, she seems okay, currently.
I give her a wink.
She's very much like, again, like, all of you are like, oh, what the fuck? It's like being flashbanged. Yeah. As your head's clear, you notice these things. So, yeah, like, things are getting progress. Like, in a good 10 feet around you, Notos, things are, like, chilling.
It's like the epicenter is me.
Yeah. I think as you move, you notice, like, the lines blur. Like, you see the some boxes start to, behind you, if you, like, take a step backwards, the boxes behind you start to, like, frost up. The box in front of you, like, thaw. However, like, as you can feel, like, small amounts of metadimensional energy, you can try and, like, actively contain this if you want.
So make
like,
a mental save.
Maybe not mental save, but, like, trying to think of, like, if there's a good skill check for this. What's a skill check for meditation?
Mental save is all I can think of from looking at them.
Yeah, I'm just trying to think, because it's not quite what I mean.
Yeah,
like, I think basically it's like if you
religion.
Yeah, religion with Wiz. I'll give you that because your whole religion is built around like worship of psionic. So like meditation for psionic control is like a thing that everyone does as prayer. It's just for some of you, it's more important than others.
Eight.
Yeah, so you can, like, contain it. Like, this, like, cold aura shrinks, and, like, you can still... You feel, like, chill in your bones, like, you just... That feeling of you can't quite get warm. And, yeah, I think... So what it's going to do is containing it, like, puts a psi point on hold.
Okay.
So we'll work out how that mechanically works and see if you can get yourself fixed. Yeah. Right. Repsol, you can't read anymore. You have become illiterate. Yeah, and seemingly, Riley, you're fine.
Guys, yeah, can't read.
Yeah, and Adam is dying on the floor.
And Adam's dying, but he hates his head.
Yeah, I mean, all of you can see this. Like, you're all close enough.
But guys.
I'm checking Apple over to make sure she's okay.
Yeah, it's the thing of, like, yeah, she seems all right at the moment. Yeah, I guess you'll see.
I guess my character is... Have I got, like, my wits about me?
Yeah, I think you just kind of, like, take a moment, and then you, like, you follow your training. And it takes you maybe only a small amount of time, but, like, you feel, like, the psychic muscles in your brain, like, expanding, contracting around this new power that you can feasibly control to some degree. But just, it's like a... This thing you have to hold the reins of. Thank you, by the way, Cracky, for the £50 earlier that caused all these horrible things. But yeah. So yeah, Adam is on the floor, like, rolling around. Like, blood is, like, pouring out of his eyes. Aku, like, kind of notices.
A medical and, like, check on him to see, like, if he is doomed.
Do it.
That attribute is wisdom, isn't it?
Yes, in this case. Because you're very much not working from anything you know of. Yeah, so he's suffering the effects of if, like, an untrained psychic uses, like, large-scale powers. His brain is liquefying. You could maybe, like, psychically, help him divert something. You have to basically train him to be a psychic. Or train his brain to be a psychic in the next, like, couple seconds. Or put him in, like, or shut him down. Like, he needs to be unconscious or... And, like, probably more, like, knocked out. His brain function needs to slow to base breathing.
Okay, I pistol with him. I don't have a pistol.
You try to do the rifle butt to the face.
Yeah.
Okay, let's see. Because that actually kills people, usually. So, I'll let you auto-hit. Give me... What kind of skill check is it? Give me an arms. Oh, no, not an arms skill check. Like a combat primitive weapon skill check. Let you use your dex.
Primitive is
that. And this thing is like, oh, instead I use my talons, because talons don't knock people out. Oh, no. You smack him in the head, he dies. That was a 4 for the people at home. Yeah, you just hit him in the head, and it's like, his head just cracks.
Unless I knock
him out. And you hear Akko behind, he's going,
No, just looks up and just goes, unless I knocked him out, his brain would have liquefied and he would have died a more horrible death than you can possibly imagine. It didn't go so well. Apologies.
That's great, guys. But on the other hand, I still can't read. I'm going to wander over to a different area and see if I still can't read.
Yeah, like, it's less that, like, the letters, like, change shape into characters from other languages. Like, you recognize them, but, like, they don't fit together, and, like, they'll rearrange order or float around in front of you, like, your vision. It's more like, kind of, I think, a case of, like, what we're told dyslexia is like, and then multiplied by, like, 100. Of, it goes from difficult to impossible. Like, the words do not stay in one place.
I'm going to go get my vac suit. I'll be right back.
Okay. Don't know what that's going to happen. So, yeah, the rest of you...
I know. It's like, something has happened and I can't read. I'm going to, like, stop being infected by whatever this is that is. Who knows what the next stage of not being able to read is.
Fair enough. Yeah. So, okay, you wander off to go get your vac suit. The rest of you, do you move into the vault room?
No, so I guess, Rana, we should probably find this box then.
Yeah. So inside, yeah, there's like, it's a small little kind of secure room in here. Yeah, I think Akko's like mourning over her friend as you wander in. And yeah, you find like, there's a couple things in here marked with like different seals for different companies. Most of them are SOC. But yeah, one end is this big box, like box is maybe 8 or 9 feet by 8 or 9, like 8 or 9 feet, 8 or 9 feet, like square on the top, and then like 4 feet deep. And yeah, it's this kind of like gunmetal grey, like it looks very secured, but there's like a light blinking on like the little console it's got, like a little red light. I think the message saying like containment breach. What do you two do?
I reckon you can unbreach that.
You muted her. I think.
I don't know. Maybe you could just give me a second without killing someone. That'd be fantastic, and I'll actually see if I can sort something out. I'll go over and sort of give it a once over. Is it like blatantly leaking gas from something?
There's no like obvious stuff coming out of it.
Cool. So well.
Yeah, like.
Is that the box we need?
Yes, that is. That is that matches the picture. There's a little serial number print on it. That is the box you want.
How big is it? Is it?
Like 8, 9 feet, 8 feet by 8 feet square on the top, 4 feet deep. It's pretty big. You need like a loader. There will be some in this.
How much strength do you need to lift it?
You could probably do it with 18 strength, with the full on telekinesis.
Cool. I go over to a loader and I've always wanted to do this, and I want to climb into one of the loaders, and like as they're going over to like examine this box, I just want to say, get away from that box, you bitch! And then I'm like, come lumbering over in power armor.
So yeah, as I say, like again, this thing is blinking and saying there's a containment fault.
Yeah, I don't care.
Okay. I mean, you want to.
If I can't see anything that's going to kill me, it's probably radiation, in which case, I don't fucking know how radiation works.
You are about to put it on your own ship.
Yeah.
Are we?
Okay. Well, this is the box you want, so. If you want it back, that's what you're planning to do.
Then we're going to. Oh, no. I know what we can do. We can get the pilot to pick it up, hold Akko as hostage until he drops it off.
You say this in front of Akko as well. This comes over the comms, Repsol.
I can't read anything, and that's awful. We want these people to go away, and so they don't hate us so much. It's just a deal that went bad, and that kind of happens. And like, that's fine. People get over that. We don't want this protracted kidnapping. People tend to take that shit pretty badly.
Hold on. Right. Someone go back and ask the pilot, and if he doesn't cooperate, then bring him here.
No, we don't. Just get back to probably, I don't know. How worse can it get?
The thing is, though, like, if your theory is that this is radiation, you would be like, your vac suits last a few hours before seals break down. In the space of normal radiation. And, like, normal radiation doesn't cause you to stop being able to read. Like, let's just put that out there.
Yeah.
You don't rapidly develop...
Can we open this box and look inside?
It's my best.
Well, as he's wandering over to get it, like, to get the thing, you can try. I mean, I don't know whether it's the thing of, like, it's got security on it. Of, like, computer locks and stuff like that. Or you can just try and prise it open with telekinetic strength.
Well, I guess it's already broken.
There's a little, like, yeah, I think maybe so what's happened is, like, one of the, like, latches has loosed. And, like, the tiniest gap is open.
Can I, like, just seal
close
it?
The patch?
Feasible, yeah. I think with a. Is it complex manipulation, or is it just telekinetic press?
Shut up. I turn to Akko and I say, sweetheart, you know you brought some adhesive sealant that basically that sealed the breach. Where exactly did you store it? Because you'd need more than one as a failsafe. I just need to borrow some of that real quick because we're gonna bag this.
Right, she's like moved back. She's sitting against like the wall thing. She just points at Adam. It's on him.
I go over and I like I. I give her a little hug and I say, look, it's all going to be over soon. And then
I think even your charm is like she shrinks from you at this stage. Like, there's only a point of when you can be charming. Like,
I haven't hurt any of her friends, though.
I know, but you wander around and you have banter with the bird demon that's murdered her friends. She's never seen an Avok in her life, and the one time she does, she wants to murder two people.
Are you guys done with her? Like, you're not going to ask Akko to do anything more, are you? Is that okay? Is Akko...
I had no plans for her other than just identifying stuff that is worth a lot that we can take off this.
Okay, she doesn't need to be here for that. You over there. Do you need her for anything? Are we good?
I mean, she does need to be here for that because she has the knowledge.
Open fear in Echo's eyes as you're
She can go now, can't she? Yeah? Is that good?
No, we need her for identifying. Do you know what stuff is expensive and worth a lot here?
Apparently shiny stuff. That's why this all kicked off. So we'll just go with the shiny stuff and the stuff that's making people radioactively bleed out of their nostrils.
Well, we need to keep her here until we can get safely away so the pilot doesn't do anything stupid.
Okay, all right. Then get the pilot.
We will not harm her.
Get the pilot off the ship and get the pilot to come here. Because then he can't move the ship and everything's fine. Let's do that now, and I'll have a go at cracking this lock. Deal?
Okay. Sure, so, like, Akka goes, I'll call Goro.
We'll call... Is Goro the shuttle pilot?
No, so Goro is the ship's pilot.
Okay.
Like, their ship that's stationed a little way away. The specific shuttle they were using is, like, one of the people who was here drove it.
Cool. I just say, look, ask Goro, tell him that we're gonna need a little time. Just basically, I'm on your side here, okay? I'm trying to make sure everything's fine. Just don't mention us and tell him that we'll leave loads of loot and everything like that. In fact, just don't mention the death or anything like that. Just enjoy it.
Yeah, she kind of nods, picks up a compad and like goes to move away and starts tapping buttons on it. So you go to fuck with the
Oh, I watch her because I don't trust this girl to do what I just said. Because I'm like trying to reassure her, but at the same time, like, please don't fuck me over. Because
don't do anything stupid. Yeah, I don't think she's willing to do anything stupid at this stage. Sure. She types out a message. She's just like, progress report. Run into like hazards aboard the ship. Gonna take a few more hours. Cool. Get back in.
Yeah.
Cool. And she just like kind of nods. Send.
Cool. I turn. She can go now. Yeah, is that okay? Is everything okay? We don't need her to identify valuables. We just need her to just tell the ship the back off. Is that okay? Can she go?
I would like identification of valuables, but fuck it, I can't.
I mean, she has as much access to these computer systems as you do. So
cool. In which case, I shoot her in the back of the head, and we get on with.
I knew that was coming. Yeah. So like, you say. Like, good, good. And you just blow like the.
This
head
is the
to
thing
here.
We get grudges for.
No, why do we get grudges? Look, you've already killed all of her friends. We're fucked as enough as it is. I don't have time to babysit her. You want shiny stuff? Go find your fucking shiny stuff. You with me? We're gonna figure out what the fuck this thing is, and we're gonna get it off. I just bought us 4 hours on the ship because she said it was all good. Now, fine, let's get on with stuff. And you guys, those incompetent people, are quite fun. To work.
Just gonna say fun.
Notos starts moving all the other boxes in this room into the shuttle, assuming that
stuff
in here is valuable as it was behind that door.
That's fair, that's fair.
I roll maximum that I can possibly roll on a computer skill check on this lock.
Okay, yeah, you access the subsystems. Like, the sealant will require like a proper like fixing, like a post-tech check, or maybe just like physically like... Because do you have is it telekinetic press is what you've got?
I've got level 2 one, so mine's just brute strength.
Okay, you might be able to hammer that thing back into place with that.
Yeah, I can lift up to 200 kilos.
Okay, yeah, I think feasibly he could, like, just hammer that down, or you could do some, like, post-tech stuff to try and, like, fix it, or you could open it. Up to you, Ryla.
I am going to try and fix it. I don't want to open it.
Okay, yeah, you Yeah, you mess with systems. Yeah, so, like, it gives you a readout. It shows you vitals.
Cool.
Like, as you access the computer system, it goes, like, there's a bunch of, like, vital signs, subject is still under, like, leak is causing no major issues with the subject's health, like, heart rate, brain function, all still within acceptable values for cryo storage.
I say, good, cool, whoever's sealed in this pod quite clearly isn't dead, so we should move this, like, now.
Okay. So you click the locks into place, so you can get at them. And, like, pull up the, like, here's how the fucking locks work, so you can fix it. Give me a post-tech check and take a +1, because you rolled so well on the computers that it tells you how to fix it, basically.
Post-tech, I already have.
Should I know you're post-tech. Yeah.
Yes. So, it's why I didn't take a rocket launcher and several other things, because I was like, or I could just buy an arseload of training and be good at stuff. That's intelligence, isn't it? Yeah.
Yes, in this case it's intelligence.
A +1. Wow. I'm gonna re-roll that.
Okay, yep.
Oh god, thank god you're an expert.
Yeah.
Because balls to that. +1. I'll take a 12.
Yeah, sure. You like, thing kind of like clicks open, you wrench a few things around, like repair some busted parts, hit a button, and yeah, just like,
seals up. And it's like there's a moment where like all the lights flash on, and it's like do 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 do, and he's like, everything looks terrible, and he's like, nah, I'm just fucking with you, and then he just clicks a button and it seals.
Yeah, it's like sealant at 100%. Okay, cool. So takes a little bit of doing. You load up stuff into that shuttle. Notos, I think as you're loading stuff up, that you like walk over to the nav computer and it goes return to point of like home point or point of origin, and like you get a thing beeping out of like it has a direct comm link to a ship called the Serpentine.
So guys, wanna hijack a ship?
That seems harder to get away with in terms of papers than like just the shuttle. Just the shuttle we can.
Papers are not a thing you need to worry too much about.
As long as we have the clicky thing that unlocks the ship, it's our ship. That's essentially.
I was gonna
how
say,
it,
if yeah. We return on the ship. We send a message that we're coming back. Return on the ship. Pilot lets us in, and then we have a ship.
Like the thing about it is, so like, if these guys have friends who are badass bounty hunters who like go, hey, our buddy's ship has been, they find it and they find you driving it, they might take issue with that. But that's a lot of ifs.
Nice ship.
The other thing is, if they owe money on it, someone might come looking for the ship. But those are the only two. Like, no one. The people who like you've dealt with enough large corporations between you to know the person who owns the like who want they want money. They don't care who's paying it.
Cool, guys. Pay the ship. Yeah.
I'm just gonna say I can fly a ship because I have vehicle space, and also on top of that, I'm an expert, so I can reroll shit. And on top of that, we can just respray it. So yeah, let's do that. Yeah.
Take the ship.
And it means we can carry even more loot as we can fill their ship and the Texas Ranger.
Yeah.
We can clear this thing out.
Yeah.
Well, no, we can take 2/10 of what's in here, was what you said.
Yeah, something like that. Smuggling a whole bunch of old Earth artifacts might be worth a chunk of money. But okay, cool. So you all get in the shuttle, like loading it up with the assorted bits and pieces.
Avoid as many Earth artifacts as possible, and much as we want to carry the other stuff that they're carrying.
Yeah, fair. You're not working for the SOC.
Yeah, so we're trying to avoid this. We're trying to get the stuff the SOC was carrying on the behalf of other people more than SOC stuff, because SOC stuff is kind of worthless to everyone who isn't the SOC, basically. And we can't sell them back their own shit.
To be fair, that's not necessarily true. Like, in this, it's basically the SOC are the king of antique dealers. But then again, how much money do you think you could make if you could sell Tutankhamun's mask? If you could find a buyer for Tutankhamun's mask who wasn't the British Museum.
True.
And, like, how many people would want that?
We've got a stolen ship. We may as well find stolen goods.
Yeah.
But, yeah, okay,
say
so you...
go with the easy-to-resell,
yeah.
Wait, can we check the ship's logs to see if they have, like, a listing of value or how much they've been paid to carry certain goods?
Oh, yeah. We'll sort that in, like, post, and I'll do something. Let's deal with hijacking a ship first, because that's more interesting to watch.
Sure.
So, yeah, you're all in the shuttle. Ryla pulls the thing out of, like, unclamps it from the side, and it starts to, like, putter its way across space.
I'm going to quickly text across saying, like...
I was going to say text across beforehand.
Saying like, we're heading back. May take a couple of runs. Okay. So, yeah.
Yeah, you get back and say, all good from the Scorer guy.
Cool.
Come meet you in the hangar and help you load.
Cool.
Unload the shell.
Cool.
Yeah. So, yeah, you like, dock... the doorways open up, and there's a Japanese guy, like, turns, like a good chunk older, like, maybe, like, early 40s, probably the oldest guy from the ship, and he turns and sees you guys all stepping out, presumably guns drawn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How long does he live?
No, shoot him. 0 seconds.
Cool, yeah, no, he has no time to really, you just... I think, yeah. Whoever wants to shoot him just shoots him and he dies.
All of us. I feel like
all three of us.
Yeah, so you start, like, yeah, I guess Ryder starts moving through the ship and, like, it's essentially, like, a similar thing to the Texas Ranger. It's a little more specialized for salvaging kind of stuff as opposed to smuggling. They have, a kind of equivalent of a tow rope. They can basically, like, it's essentially, like, the idea of they can attach, like, a big clamp onto this ship and they could kind of give it a bit of juice. It couldn't drag it through spike drive space, but they could move it around the sector itself, or like a good few.
We could hide this somewhere.
Space miles.
That means we can hide it basically, because that is if exactly we can, because if it's not where people expect it to be, because we got given coordinates where it is,
yeah.
We put it somewhere else.
And
you got coordinates for its last transmission.
Found potentially and specifically not with that on it. So how about it's a ship armed.
This ship has no guns.
Just the Texas Ranger
has a multifocal laser, which is, it's not ideal if you want to, like, yeah, like, full-on destroy this thing.
No, right, got an idea. I say we tow the ship to a part of space where it isn't at the moment, and then we get Texas Ranger to put some holes in the, enough holes in it to make it look like the ship got scuttled by pirates, and then random shit will be missing, and it'll look like a random raid. And no one will look specifically at what's been taken because we have just taken random shit that's valuable. And hopefully no one will look too too detailed into the manifest.
I 100% agree on that plan.
Cool.
Yeah, so you all set to doing that. Like, you get on the horn with Schofield. Say you've claimed a ship. He's like, I'm not even going to ask.
I won't ask.
Right. Yeah, you start, like, booting up the loading bay stuff and start moving cargo across.
What class of ship is this? Is this a free merchant?
This would be a free merchant, yeah.
Cool.
And we also signal what's his face to come round and...
Walker. Yeah, he starts doing that. No, sorry, not Walker. It's Walker Schofield.
Does he have scuttle ship to pick stuff up as well?
Not really. As I say, this ship is built for like scavenging operations.
Well, we do now have a shuttle.
Salvaging.
Cool.
Yeah. Whereas his one is built for, like, smuggling. He doesn't often jettison stuff. He makes it so that his ship is never found in the first place. So you set to work. You're doing that for a little while. Notos. I think, actually, so there's a... Yeah, Notos, you get a little ding on your phone. And it's a coded transmission. In system.
Meaning...
As in, like, there's a ship within system who's broadcasting to you on encrypted secret channels that haven't been activated on your, like, because this is a device from AVOC, presumably. Is your planet's called AVOC, isn't it?
Yeah.
So this is the device from AVOC, and, like, given to you by the people who you left on your little pilgrimage. So they're broadcasting you on an encrypted secret channel. On that phone.
Can I... If it's encrypted, can I read it or not?
Oh yeah, like, it's just call. The thing is, it's not going through the ship's comm system.
Oh right.
It's going direct to you. That's my point. So the rest of your crew doesn't necessarily know you're doing this.
Okay, so I... find out what it says.
Yeah, so you get a message and a little, like, maybe it's like one of those hologram displays, like a little, like a kind of an avatar of a much like sterner looking Eivok than yourself, like kind of red and like I think maybe it's like purple plumage, kind of comes on. It's like an audio track that's playing. It's like a so. Adept Notos, our sensors indicate that you are within system. As this is an empty part of space, we assume this is no coincidence. The great spirits lead all things for a reason. We require if you are available, we require your assistance. There is a transport ship belonging to a human organization known as the SOC. In system, it was carrying a specific piece of cargo. Is it the Great Mother? Is the like top of like your big religious idol? Yeah, it's like
no, it's the Wind Waker.
The Wind Waker, that's it. The Wind Waker.
Disgusting.
I know, right? It's like the Wind Waker felt a storm brewing on a distant planet. In the Amin sector, we believe this SOC ship has somehow claimed this storm. Visions of the future are, as ever, full of trickery. But it seems to have moved, and we have tracked it to this ship, to this sector. If you are knowledgeable of anything that would be there, we will be at your location within 15 minutes. Your cooperation would stand you well in our stead. Transmission ends. And like the Wind Waker having visions means, and like calling it the Great Storm and stuff like that, it's like, yeah, that's your natural gut reaction would be the box and the thing in it that caused you all to like go kind of insane.
Notos doesn't say anything, just kind of like tries to delay things subtly, like slows down.
Okay.
I kind of sends him a message. I'm already here. Sends him a message along the lines of, I'm already here, have possession of the...
Possession object.
Of the... No, not of the...